It's hockey night tonight. Tension grows, the whistle blows, and the puck goes down the ice. The goalie jumps and the players bump, and the fans all go insane. Someone roars, Bobby scores at the good old hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game. Second period, where players dash with skates aflash, the home team trails behind. But they grab the puck and go bursting up, and they're down across the line. They storm the crease like bumblebees, they travel like a burning flame. We see them slide the puck inside, it's a 1-1 hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game. Third period, last game in the playoffs too. Oh, take me where the hockey players face off down the rink. And the Stanley Cup is all filled up for the champs who win the drink. Now the final flick of a hockey stick and a one gigantic scream. The puck is in, the home team wins the good old hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game.
That's it!
And welcome again to the Big Pond at the Illinois Ice Arena. We are ready for Illini hockey once again. Ori Benatar here alongside Patrick Catazone. What a game we had last night, Illinois winning 3-2 in a shootout. Yep. It was a good game.
Absolutely. It's a very frustrating game for about, I don't know, what was that, 50 minutes?
Yeah, like
and
50.
There was 50 minutes to start the game, and it was absolutely very frustrating for the Illini. They couldn't get anything going offensively, but they were able to, last couple what, 5 minutes there, they were able to score two goals real quick and force an overtime where, love seeing some Grand Prix hockey here at the Big Pond, and it was a great game, and they went into a shootout, and I believe it was Casper Ribba, right, who scored.
Yeah, Ribba got the one goal in the shootout. He had a couple of good chances during the game, but my goodness, Illinois just seemed like down and out in this one. They definitely had no edge in the game. Like, the first period, they were quiet.
Yeah.
They had a couple power plays in there, but they weren't able to get shots off.
No.
But then, quick turnaround in the third. It looked like all hope was lost. Early goal in the third for Central Oklahoma. Then Illinois had penalty after penalty, and then they got the shorthanded goal from Neil Novosel.
Yeah, so, looking back, going into this game, We actually said it at intermission yesterday. Get going early because with only five defensemen, it's going to get hard to get back in this game, and it was absolutely difficult to get back in that game last night. We were fortunate enough to do it and get the win, a very important win as well, coming off of a three-game losing streak. So, once again, get going early for the Illini and hopefully score on some of those opportunities because the opportunities were there in that first period. But nothing was going to the back of the net, so
yeah.
Try and change it up somehow.
I definitely think that the area of improvement for Illinois is probably going to be on both ends of the power play. On the end where they're on the power play, got to get shots off early. There were so many instances where Illinois couldn't get that first shot off till about a minute 10 into the power play, and also they got to be more disciplined. Central Oklahoma came in as one of the top penalty teams in the ACHA in this big non-conference game, and they were a more disciplined team. There were a couple scuffles in there, but Illinois had a lot of penalties, including two big ones in the third. The last one eventually led to a shorthanded, but they got to be more disciplined, but they also got to get a lot of shots on their power plays.
Right, and you mentioned discipline, and a lot of that goes with how aggressive the Illini are going to be. Some nights we see an aggressive team, and I think going into this the game last night, we're thinking really aggressive, try and get the puck as much as they can. And I think that worked for most part. They were able to get a couple checks that resulted in the puck turning over. So as long as they could try and keep on doing that without being too, you know, indisciplined and making mistakes and getting into the penalty box, they should be good.
Central Oklahoma also, I mean, they were the better team in that game last night.
Oh, absolutely.
Sure. Illinois just had those 75 seconds of glory, and then we had that insane 20, 25, 30 minutes, however long it was, of just nothingness happening where they were fixing the boards, and we didn't realize because it was in our blind spot. But for Central Oklahoma, what's it going to take for them to actually get a win tonight and hand Illinois their first home loss this season?
So, you know, I just mentioned it earlier, too. They have to get off to a fast start because they were very slow to start this game. And then once they started getting into a groove, they scored two goals in the later two periods. So, hey, score early again if you're Oklahoma, Central Oklahoma on this one, and try and put as many points together as you can because, honestly, this Illini hockey team is resilient, which is a great trait to have for the Illini. Try and avoid that. Score as early as you possibly can and try and put them down early and get a good amount of insurance goals. So hopefully, you know, if you're Oklahoma, that's your move.
Right, and there were a lot of good players last night. And who in particular do you see as potentially someone who is going to have another good game? You look at John Moskaluk. He got a lot of shots off for Illinois, getting that game-tying goal. Alex Henry was saving everything until that third period late. And then you also have the efforts of Matt Davies for Central Oklahoma. Illinois also had that great shot from Neil Novosel. Jack Graham had a pretty good game defensively. So I think between Moskaluk and Alex Henry, they were probably the two best players in the game between the two teams. Which one do you think is going to come out and have another good game tonight?
Well, I like that first line with John Moskaluk, so I imagine he's going to have a good game. But another name I'd like to mention is Joe Nolan on the defense. I think he's the heart of that defense. He played really well. He had some great handles last night that resulted in some good opportunities, but they weren't going in the back of the net, and that's going to happen sometimes. So, look to him again, too, to try and set some guys up, and hopefully we can score off those opportunities. But him and Moskaluk are the guys I'm looking for in this game.
Yeah, and also, this is your first time doing color, Patrick.
Yeah.
Are you excited?
I am excited. I hope, we saw a great game last night. Hopefully we'll get another great game tonight here. So make sure you stay tuned because these two teams like to fight, and it's always exciting.
Yeah, and once again, this is going to be a radio broadcast. We apologize for the inconvenience with the video. This is the first time this has happened with this broadcast over the past year. This video thing was still kind of new, but obviously we are going to stick to a radio broadcast. We hope that you stay with us. I'm sure it's going to be another fantastic hockey game, and we are going to be working on those video kinks, and hopefully it will be solved potentially for the road trip to Lindenwood, Illinois. Their next game is at Lindenwood for the next weekend, but then after that, home matches against Robert Morris. The weekend before the election, so that should be pretty interesting. We'll hopefully have everything sorted out. Again, we apologize for the inconvenience, but we're all going to be here today, and we're all going to be talking some hockey as the referees are now skating out on the ice, and Central Oklahoma has come out to the ice for their final warm-ups. Once again, wearing their blue and different shade of maize jerseys. That's something Steven was commenting on yesterday.
Yep.
Similar-ish to Michigan, but that yellow's a bit brighter. But I really like their uniforms.
Yeah, they're good-looking uniforms, blue and maize. They Michigan won earlier, so if that's any sign in this game, might see a Central Oklahoma win.
And the Illini come out now as well.
Yeah. You mentioned earlier, too, the two teams coming up for the Illini. A little bit of a tale of two cities there. Lindenwood, one of the best teams in the conference in the entire Division One. They're ranked number two, so be a big game there. But on the other side, Robert Morris having a tough season this year. So hopefully to get wins both of those trips.
We'll see how it happens as we are just a few minutes away from puck drop. Player introductions will be coming up shortly. We'll give you the audio for that as well as the national anthem. And then we will have the first period here. Again, to remind you, last night Illinois was down 2-0 early in the third period, and they scored twice in the third to tie the game at 2, winning in a shootout last night. They are 5-0 at home, looking to keep it at 6-0. Let's take it now to the public address announcer for the player introductions for tonight's game.
Between the Central Oklahoma Also at defense, number 24, Alex Derwinick. And starting goal, number 57, Cody Campbell. The Broncos head coach is Craig McAllister.
National Anthem player introductions in the books as we're ready to get this hockey game started. Change for Central Oklahoma in between the sticks. Cody Campbell will make his fifth appearance this season, coming in with a 2-1 record and a 2 goals against average and a very good 93.7 save percentage, while Illinois will stick with Jake Barnhart in the net for the seventh game of the season for him, giving up 2 goals last night and not conceding during the shootout.
Yeah, Barnhart played a good game yesterday, but credit to the other side as well. Two great games from the goalies that had to come to OT, and for the most part, they both played a fantastic game for the 55 minutes, and Illini just were able to pull away at the end, so good job on both sides there, and I imagine we'll see more good play from the two of them tonight as well.
Yeah, and Alex Henry and Cody Campbell have kind of been alternating throughout the season. Henry's got 7 games, Campbell has got 5. So head coach Craig McAllister switching between those goaltenders despite the great performance from Alex Henry last night. But Cody Campbell does come in with the better goals against average and the better save percentage. Illinois' lines are unchanged once again with only 5 defensemen in the lineup. And we're underway here at the Big Pond, the second game between Illinois and Central Oklahoma. Illinois is trying to remain unbeaten at home while the Broncos of Central Oklahoma look to get a victory against the Illini in the second of 2 games as Illinois has the puck in the offensive zone, beginning with that first line as it passed into the middle of the net, and it's taken by Alex Durbinek, the captain for Central Oklahoma, who rushes down ice into the offensive zone there. Quick pass, and it almost was deflected by Niall Mills as Central Oklahoma looking to keep it in their offensive zone.
Nice breakup there by Illini's defense.
Mills behind the net. Salk in there, pass out to the point, good shot, deflected off the defender. Now Bobby Ernstein gets it, pass into the neutral zone to Moskaluk, who's going to dump it off. Cody Campbell's going to get a touch on it, and he's going to pass it to his teammate, Donald Danroth. Comes in with 8 goals this season. Rushes down through the neutral zone, nice move by Danroth, trying to now get by Jack Graham. Stuck into the corner between Graham, and good pressure there from Graham, giving the puck to Joe Nolan. Nolan now rushing down. He's got two players to his left side. It's Richter and Forfar. Pass in the middle to Forfar. Richter trying to get a shot off there. Still the puck is alive. Now it's going to fly out deep into Illini defensive territory. Jack Graham getting it.
Good pass there from Nolan. Like to see him get pucks to the center. Forfar just unable to complete that pass.
Forfar trying to clear it again. Oh, and pass in the middle of the net hit. But Central Oklahoma now near the blue line. Quick wrist shot. Comes off of Nolan. Now another potential chance for Alexander Yamayev. Trying to pass it into the middle, and Central Oklahoma keeps it. And we'll have a whistle here at 18:28 in the first.
Yeah, Nolan made a little mistake there. Tried to get the, you know, handle the puck there and lost control of it, gave it back to Oklahoma. So hopefully that doesn't happen too often. But the second line in two right now as well, and a good line so far. See if they can get the puck to the center of Forfar.
Shot off of the stick of Forfar. That came from Davin Burton of Central Oklahoma, who've been able to keep the puck for a majority of the beginning of this first period. As this one is tipped off, Illinois making a line chase here. Central Oklahoma's Henry Hoffman has it, passing it in, and it hits off of the skate of Justin Reese, but back into the sticks of Central Oklahoma. Moving it up ice now, a little pass into the middle, and a little bit of a giveaway. Reese now on the right side of Cody Campbell's net. Scuffle on the boards. Reese now getting it out, looking for a pass to Opilka, who's in front of the net. That was Healy looking for Opilka. Now a pass into the middle, deflected down onto the ice by Quinn, tries to get a shot, puck flying in the air, still stays in play though, and Illinois retrieving it once again. Precos passes it inside. That one's going to hit off the boards. Puck is open now. Opilka. Nice little ding pass, but now a one-on-one here with Central Oklahoma. A shot, and it's wide. Rebounded once again, and the Broncos are looking to take advantage and capitalize here with Brandon Formosa trying to get a return pass, but unable to, and now Illinois is going to try and rush up ice. In the neutral zone, good poke checks there by Austin Cunningham of Central Oklahoma on Stephen Quinn, and passed out by Campbell. Net open, pass it in the middle, quick, and Campbell able to recover and make a save. Good chance, now a shot from Quinn, and it's grabbed by Cody Campbell for the save. A 17:08 on the clock.
Yeah, poor decision there from Campbell. Just got to let that puck go, let your defenseman get to it. Or even if an Illini player gets to it first, you know, might as well give up that that possession there to just make sure you cover the goal. Guys, don't give up anything too early here against this Illini team.
Neil Novosel wins the faceoff. Hatton trying to get the shot. Flung up into the air, and now Evan Sabo, the speedster on this team, passes it into the backboards. And now Central Oklahoma with the puck now in the neutral zone is Braden Hull. Moving it around in the defensive zone. Less than 17 minutes now in the first period. Still no score. Neither team was able to score in last night's game in the first. Three Illini defensemen against one Central Oklahoma attacker, which was Yamayev. Barnhart's going to touch it. Grabbed by Joe Nolan. Nice pass around the boards. And here comes Sabo rushing down ice. Two defenders trying to catch up with him. He tries to get around. Looked like Hull. Now behind the net, looking to a center pass inside to Novosel. Can't get it, and now Central Oklahoma's going to rush up ice.
Aggressive play so far from Central Oklahoma as they clear a puck. Opilka looks like he's going to control it.
It's Nolan now passing it to Novosel. Reba now to Moskaluk. He scored last night looking for a similar goal, and his slap shot misses the net. Riba able to recover it, passing it to Moskaluk, hit on the boards by Cartwright. Comes back out to Central Oklahoma, less than 16 minutes now in the first period. Both teams have had a couple of chances, but no clear-cut opportunities quite yet, but a faster start to what we saw last night.
Yeah, Moskaluk, I like that shot there. Why not take it? He likes that spot on the ice. He scored there from there last night, so good shot from him.
Moskaluk again. Passing it to Bobby Ernsting, the faceoff meister for this Illini hockey team, but his pass falls right into Central Oklahoma. They're trying to get out of their defensive zone. Good pressure from the Illini forward lines, but Central Oklahoma's finally going to clear it. It's going to go all the way down the ice, And it is going to be an icing call. 15:22 to go.
Yeah, it was a good choice, I think, there to take a line change. They did a quick dump on the offensive side and got some of the guys who've been on the ice for a while off. And now we got the second line in. And watch out for Nolan on this possession. He's in a good spot if Forfar can win the faceoff.
Forfar taking the faceoff for Illinois against Matt Davies, who scored his first goal of the season and the first of the game for the Broncos last night. That broke the deadlock middle of the second period. Illinois does win the faceoff. Forfar behind the net. He's trying to keep it with him. But Central Oklahoma passing it around as they've been able to keep the defensive going. But Richter now gets it to Forfar. Middle pass, and it's unable to get it on target there. Was the Illini defenseman.
Good chance. Good chance, opportunity there for Richter. Good pass. Try and get as much going early in front of the net as you possibly can.
Pass dumped off, and another icing call for the Broncos, stopping the clock at 14:48. So far, both teams have been rushing up ice pretty well, but not been able to capitalize on those last two, three passes.
No, this is a different start for the Illini than it was last night. Possessions really haven't been too steady, really. A lot of back and forth, like you mentioned.
Justin Reese on the faceoff now in the Illini offensive zone, wins it. Trying to get it back to Stephen Quinn. Precos was skating near it, but now it's going to be won by Central Oklahoma. This is Donald Danroth. He's going to check Quinn into the boards. He falls, hits his head, stick away, still on the ice. He takes his glove off. He's still in pain here, but he is trying to skate off the ice, and he is going to come off for a substitution. Potential injury there for Stephen Quinn. Looks like he hit his head on the boards, skating with his own willpower to the bench. We'll update you if he continues to play this game. We will see. But his glove and stick are still on the ice to the right side of Jake Barnhart's net. Now Evan Sabo moving up. 14:09 to go in the first. Quick shot from Sabo and a good glove save there by Cody Campbell.
Yeah, another good spot there for Sabo. I like to shoot it right there, right almost on the red line for the offensive zone. And hopefully Quinn's not out for too long. He is tied as the league scorer for the Illini.
Yeah, he kind of, his knees were on the ice. He kind of got hit there, and I think he kind of went like head first there, but like the top of his head, not like his forehead.
Yeah, and I think he's squeezing his hand. So, yeah, he can't really tell even what he's doing right now. He's got his hands on his head, so maybe you're right there. It could be a head injury as well as maybe a hand injury. We'll see, but he's wincing in pain right now.
Paul Precos is also looking to get checked. He was running around the boards. So Illinois, who have a bit of an injury bug right now, can't afford too much more.
No, that would put us down to four defensemen.
13:49 to go in the first. Still no score in this game. As Central Oklahoma have a 1-on-2 here with Daughtry. Good defending there from Charlie Sulk. Trying to get around the Central Oklahoma forward line. Now Neil Novosel scored a great goal last night on the shorthand, and he gets hit hard into the boards by Central Oklahoma's Davin Burton. And now a bit of a misconnect there between the two sides, and Landon Robin, who scored last night, he gets the puck now with Central Oklahoma. Can't get it out of their defensive zone. Illinois is putting a lot of pressure on the Central Oklahoma defensemen so far.
Yeah, good play so far.
Now Bobby Ernsting trying to get a rush here for Illinois. Moving to his right side around Alexander Yamayev. Nice pass out to Moskaluk. He's going to try and keep the puck here. It falls all the way back towards the boards of Campbell. But Central Oklahoma winning it back. Illinois at the point now. Quick shot from Graham and almost deflected in by Moskaluk. But just wide of the net. Doesn't test Campbell too much.
Yeah, good job keeping the puck in the offensive zone there for the Illini. Defensemen do look a little tired, though. Looking to get back early.
Graham retrieving it. Pass off of the board. Going to roll its way around, and it's going to be collected by Drake Cartwright. Now to Hull. Hull moving it into the middle of the ice, looking for a shot, and an easy catch for Jake Barnhart with 12:18 left in the first at 7:15 p.m.
Yeah, and Precos not back in this game, so looks like the Illini will go with four defensemen for a little while, and it'll be interesting to see what they do. They try and mix up the lines a little bit to try and get some more rest, and they're in a sticky situation now.
Faceoff won by Central Oklahoma in the offensive zone, trying to get a shot. Pass around towards the back of the net. Charlie Sulk now checking a Central Oklahoma player in the board. That is Joel. Joel still has it, skating around to the opposite side of the back of the net. Central Oklahoma keeping a good string of possession here, trying to get a shot off. Now near the right circle. Joel tries to center it, but it's deflected, and it comes out to Thomas Kolaz, who's going to chip it up towards Drew Richter, but it is grabbed by Central Oklahoma. Now Central Oklahoma with a rush. Shot from Joel. Nice pad save from Barnhart as he extended that right leg. Central Oklahoma with a lot more offensive pressure in this first period compared to what we saw last night.
Yeah, absolutely. A little bit more aggressive for them so far, and they're trying as hard as they possibly can to keep it in their offensive zone here. And they, rightfully so, line of defense a little tired and a little shorthanded.
Still haven't seen Precos or Quinn yet. They both haven't checked back into the game. With 11:07 to go in the first period, Illinois now in the offensive zone. Shot there from Healy, and it comes out towards the net. Looked like it's open puck, but no one able to get a final touch on there. Is Illinois close to potentially breaking the deadlock here early in the first period, but they still have the puck now in the offensive zone. Justin Reese looking for a pass from Joe Nolan. Joe Nolan moving it around, wrist shot, trying to get a deflection off of Neil Novosel, who is going to regroup.
Yeah, good job getting the puck to the center there, trying to get as much opportunity as it possibly can.
Nolan passing it opposite side to Jack Graham. His wrist shot hits off the boards, trying to come out towards Reese in the front of the net. Now Healy there, trying to get it in, and now there's five guys roughing it around. Looked like we had a punch thrown on Graham, potentially, as an Illini player is down now, 10:32 to go. That did not look too kind. Actually, I think it's Justin Reese who got a hit.
Yeah, Matt Davis from Central Oklahoma, too. He's trying to get his close as possible he can there. Reese, he likely to go to the penalty box, I think. Maybe the both of them, but that was a little bit more of a scruff than I think we originally thought it was.
Yeah, we saw that last night, but there was definitely a cockback and a bit of a follow-through there, as there was a bit of a punch there from a Central Oklahoma player. Nothing that would instigate an all-out brawl. We don't really see that here at the Big Pond or in ACHA hockey in general, but we saw the physicality, and I think it's going to continue tonight.
Oh, for sure. And, you know, I think both sides, they want to be physical in this game, can't really get bullied around. But, interesting, they didn't go put anyone in the box. I imagine refs are going to try and keep it that way and not put too many people in.
Yeah, still no power plays for either team as they're almost halfway through the first period. Another hit there as Kolaz goes down, loses his stick. Pass to Tyler Opilka. Opilka on the left circle trying to center it. Hits off of the pad of Campbell. And Central Oklahoma trying to clear it. Opilka trying to win it back, but he hits the boards hard. And now it's deflected off, but Central Oklahoma trying to get it into the neutral zone. They finally do. Bodies flying all over the ice right now. Lots of people falling onto the sheet. And it's going to be slowed down.
Our line changed for the Illini. They went with the first string. Now it looks like they're going to go with second string Kolaz.
Salk and Nolan, the defenseman here. Dumped off by Central Oklahoma, chasing after it is Daughtry. Salk is able to get it. Both players colliding with the glass hard.
Back with the first line, excuse me. And Nolan able to get the puck, see if they can try and get the puck to the center of Estring.
Yeah, Salk passing it, but a slow line change from Illinois. Possession won back by the Broncos. Salk trying to get it. He does a little kick to Moskaluk. Central Oklahoma keeping it onside. Now kicked by Nolan into the neutral zone, and it's going to be recollected by Alex Durbinick, the captain of Central Oklahoma. Barnhart behind his net, tapping it easily. Almost a loss of possession, but Illinois able to keep it. Good pass by Salk to Moskaluk, who's open on that right corner, and he cross-ice pass to Ribba. He can't control it. Durbinick's going to chase after it. Going to get a touch there, but it's recollected by Illinois. Center pass to Moskaluk, who was in the slot, but he could not get a wrist shot off. Still with Jack Graham at the point. Pass to Moskaluk on the corner. 8:47 to go in the first period. Graham keeping it onside for Illinois, but now a chance here for Central Oklahoma. Rushing down ice, Nolan and Forfar meeting here. Backhanded shot missed by Spencer Farstad. As both teams have been able to get a couple of one-on-twos, and now another chance for Illinois coming up. Moskaluk getting poked, and it's stolen there by Landon Robin. Tremendous defense there. Landon Robin into the point, trying to get a deflection passed Barnhart. Now Illinois going to try and rush it. Puck open. 8:17 to go in the first period. Central Oklahoma rushing down now once again. Robin looking to get a shot off of the pad of Barnhart. Center pass, and that's a good save. Oh, it goes in, and it's a goal for Central Oklahoma. And nope, the referee is going to call no goal.
Yeah, great shot, you know. Great setup play. Got a man right in front of Barnhart there. Looks like that was Landon Robin.
Yeah, Robin to
thought
hole.
He scored, but
yeah.
It looks like they're going to... No, it looks like they're going to call it a goal.
Yeah, they are going to call it a goal, yeah. It was initially waved off.
No, they're not. Apparently...
We have a bit of confusion right now. The scoreboard hasn't changed. The Central Oklahoma players are celebrating with their bench.
Yeah. But Illini Hockey protesting this, really, and... I'm going to say it's a no goal. I think you got to go with the original call here on the ice. You know, there's no challenge, so you might as well stick with the first call and not second-guess yourself.
Yeah, so the officials are currently discussing to see if we have a goal here. If it is, then Central Oklahoma will have a lead here in the first period. They had a lead yesterday in the second period, as basically it was a pass from Robin behind the net, tipped in by Hole in front of Barnhart. It kind of trickled in a little bit, looked like it crossed the line, but it was initially called a no goal. The light went off, probably because of the reaction from the Central Oklahoma players, who reacted as if it was a goal, of course.
Yeah, I imagine, you know, that's going to happen, but I think, yeah, they're going to say no goal.
No,
no
goal.
There. I think froze the ice, or froze the puck there, so might as well... Don't give them the goal.
So a tough,
biased,
tough break for the Broncos there, as they're unable to take that first period lead, as it is officially called a no goal. So will there be a faceoff in the Illini's defensive territory? Big break for Illinois.
Absolutely. We talked about it in pregame. Don't want to give up anything early and try and score early. They got 8 minutes to try and figure out something. But this game's going by pretty quickly for both sides. Hard to change when there's so many rushes.
Thank everyone for joining this another edition of Illini Hockey. Sadly, no video. We're hoping to get that fixed shortly, but we are going to have a full radio broadcast here. I'm Ori Benatar, Patrick Catazone on color, and Claire O'Brien will be joining us later for the intermission reports, as Central Oklahoma's got it now. 7:48 to go. Richter falling down the ice. Chance for a shot near the right circle. As Central Oklahoma looking to respond quickly after the no-goal call that could have given them a 1-0 lead. And here they are again. Backhand towards the front of the net, flies up, but now Richter able to finally control it down. And we will have a whistle at 7:33.
Yeah, Opelka gave up the puck there in a terrible spot, so fortunate to get away with that.
And Charlie Sulk is going to go into the box for a penalty. He had a couple penalties last night, but this is the first power play of the game, and it will be for Central Oklahoma with 7:33 to go in the first period. Central Oklahoma were decent on the power play last night. Technically didn't score on the power play, because that second goal came literally as Illinois' player in the box came out of the box.
Yeah. So, but regardless, this is a good team on the power play. Lots of discipline here. We'll see if Illini could help themselves and kill us.
Illini looking for the penalty kill as Charlie Sulk is in the box. Central Oklahoma near the boards. Look, going to try and clear it.
God, I think if you're Illini too, 4-on-4 hockey sometimes helps. They almost scored two. They had an opportunity on the penalty kill to score last night.
Central Oklahoma passing it around. It was a slashing penalty, and a shot there in the slot was Mills, but he was unable to get it on net. Now once again, Owen open at the back stick there was Formosa, but it just goes through his skates. And now 1:21 to go. Again, it was a slashing call on Charlie Sulk. First power play of the game for Central Oklahoma. Neither team scored on the power play last night, but last time we had a Central Oklahoma power play between these two teams, it was an Illini shorthanded goal.
Yeah, Formosa has got to connect on that pass too to score. For Central Oklahoma, he's going to be thinking about that one in his sleep.
Illinois still hasn't been able to clear it out of the defensive zone. Slap shot, good save with the stick, and it's open in the net, and that will be a Central Oklahoma power play goal.
Yeah, they scored that one. Barnhart on his butt. Can't really help that too much. Got to clear the puck after the shot or freeze it somehow. And Barnhart unable to do that, and Illini will be down 1-0 with 6:23 left in this first period. It's an all-around good shot, and that line of defense on that penalty kill did not look good. They were unable to clear it. Can't let that happen. Can't give them that many opportunities on the power play.
Power play goal here. 1:10 into the power play, and with 6:23 left in the first period for the Broncos, and for the second night in a row, the Illini face a 1-0 deficit.
Different game, though, too, to throw that in there. It seems like Illinois has had more quality opportunities in this one.
Central Oklahoma trying to keep it once again. Opilka wishing around ice. Looking for a pass to Hatton, and now Sabo looking to get it. He gets hit with the hand, picks up his glove, loses his stick. The Illini are getting battered and bruised right now in this first period. And it doesn't help that now they have a 1-0 deficit.
Yeah, Sabo's got to get back in that game pretty quickly and try and do something. This offense got to try and get more opportunities too. Almost did there as they took a shot in the neutral zone. But
yeah, I thought Campbell was going to freeze that.
Yeah, me too. It's a bummer for the Illini.
Niall Mills scoring the goal for Central Oklahoma. His sixth of the season. He's got 11 points now on the year. 5 assists and 5 goals entering the series.
The second line on now. Here's a good opportunity.
Almost
to
a deflection there. Now frozen by Campbell. And once again, Central Oklahoma player, that is Davin Burton going after an Illini player.
Yeah, he's going after Forfar on that one. A good shot, too. I like the decision there by Joe Nolan. He took a slap shot and trying to get a redirection. I thought they should have done that a little bit more last night. Glad they did it here in this one. Hopefully we'll see a little bit more of that, too. I like the power from the defenseman. Try and get someone to redirect it.
And despite the physicality from the Broncos, a team that's known to be physical, still no penalties called on them quite yet. As Illinois have the puck in the offensive zone, this faceoff coming up between Forfar and Cartwright. It's going to be won by Forfar. Healy passing it back. Graham's shot hits off of the board near the goalkeeper, Cody Campbell. Forfar center pass, falls away. Graham wrist shot, almost trickles in, and now it's open, and it's a goal for Illinois! The final touch from Jack Healy, his first of the season. And we've got a tie game here. Quick response for the Illini.
Yeah, anytime the puck's up in the air like that, you gotta go right to the net, that's what he did. Puck was there, good shot. Great, like I said, hey, have the defenseman take a shot and try and redirect it. They did, it failed. But a great job there by Kelly to try and go to the net and try and make something happen. Because I think when you're on offense and you know, like that, that's what you got to do. You got to go right to where the puck is and try and score, and that's what they did. So
puck kind of
tied up.
Yeah, floated in the air after the shot by Graham. And then you just get a body in front, poke it in. And with 4:44 left in the first period, we have got a tie game, 1-1, after 2 goals in about a 2-minute span. A much more lively first period compared to last night, where these two teams were tied 0-0. Could see some more goals here tonight, potentially. Barnhart's going to freeze the puck after a neutral zone shot there from Gage Joel, stopping it at 4:29.
Yeah, good goal there, and it looks like, once again, Simon Hobbs for the Central Oklahoma team tonight is trying to get a little scruff there. Honestly, it looks like Central Oklahoma might be a little bit more frustrated in this game than the Illini were in last game.
In the neutral zone now, Central Oklahoma moving it past the middle of the ice. Trying to get a pass off. Now Bobby Ernsting is trying to get a rush there, but good defense by Simon Hobbs. He's able to stop a potential breakaway there for Illinois. Puck flies into the board nets. 4:05 left. Forfar and Reese got the assist on the goal. And it's a first of the season for number 19, Jack Healy of Illinois.
Yeah, and once again, that was a textbook play there by Healy. Go to the net and try and put the puck in, and did exactly that. He's rewarded with the goal.
Yeah, and that's been the case with both goals so far. You know, Central Oklahoma, backhanded deflection by Niall Mills to get that goal.
Yeah, whenever a goaltender is panicked or trying to figure out where the puck is, that's the best time to shoot the puck or try and find it yourself, really. So both goals, like you said, coming their way that way. And,
just getting in front of the net and just poking it in. So two simple goals in this first period with 4:05 to go. 1-1 between the two teams. Illinois won last night in a shootout, coming back from a 2-0 deficit in the third period. Paul Precos is back on the ice for Illinois. Ribba is open, but Novacell keeping it for himself, trying to get by the defenseman. He does, and he's going to get checked in there by Jared Guffey. Central Oklahoma trying to move it down now. Moskaluk meeting the rush from Yamayev. It's going to be passed. No icing as Joe Nolan picks it up for Illinois, and he's going to reset it here.
Yeah, obviously good goal. Good call there by the refs. No icing. Puck through there, and good job Nolan trying to find and set up the
offense.
Yeah,
we got a play here. Novacell trying to get a replay of his goal from last night, but a good pad save there from Cody Campbell with the right extension. 3:18 to go in the first after a good opportunity from Neil Novacell trying to get his second goal in two games. Another stick loss for Illinois, and moving it up ice is Graydon Hull for Central Oklahoma. Through the neutral zone, getting by a lot of Illini bodies. That puck flies into the bricks of the big pond, over the net, and out of play with 3:04 left.
Yeah, it's the second time that's happened on the offensive zone for Central Oklahoma, which again, I think that just suggests a little bit more frustration. It seems like the Illini defense playing a little bit better than this one to start off. But let's not forget that last night they also did the same thing, and that changed as soon as the second period came around. So hopefully we'll stick to the good defense.
Defensive zone faceoff win for Luke Forfar. As we're approaching the last 2 minutes of the first period. Pass into the middle. Forfar hitting it with the backhand. Hatton is going to skate after it quickly. Hoffman looking to keep it for Central Oklahoma. Good check there from Hatton.
Right there, a great example of being aggressive and getting the puck back.
Flipped into the neutral zone and picked up there by Central Oklahoma by the goal scorer, Niall Mills. Passing it around, meeting it was a blue shirt. That was Dan Roth, but now Illinois moving it up ice. Here's Sabo trying to center it. He gets hit as he's passing it. And lots of Illini players have been falling on the ice in this first period, and there's another one that just happened near the net. Mills moving it up. He gets sandwiched by Opilka as they both go down. Still in Illini defensive territory as Forfar losing it. Central Oklahoma trying to center it in towards Mills. Passed out, and it's going to be recollected by Evan Sabo, but it's going to be met by a Central Oklahoma defenseman. But now comes out near the net to Charlie Salk. Pass to Tyler Opilka. 1:50 to go in the first period in a 1-1 game here at the Big Pond Illinois Ice Arena. Pass it behind the net. No one in front of Barnhart's net, so looking for a pass to the point. Going to be a wrist shot. Good save by Jake Barnhart as that came in from Drake Cartwright.
Yeah. Absolutely, textbook play there for Barnhart, and you'll hope a little bit more often that you can control the puck there, but good save regardless.
Still with Central Oklahoma, they've had the puck in the offensive territory for a good portion of this first period. Trying to pass it into the middle, it is going to come out towards the right circle. Trying to space themselves around the ice, looking for an open shot, but Illinois' defense has been tight in this sequence. Now looking for a quick shot, and that's a good save there by Jake Barnhart with the shoulder, was going towards the top of the far post, and we have less than a minute now in the first period. Passed into the middle to Healy, looking for his second of the night, but he was unable to get with the shot. Now a one-on-one. Precos looking to defend, comes to Barnhart, he's gonna freeze the puck. That came from Austin Cunningham, and that stops the clock at exactly 48 seconds.
Two great saves there from Barnhart. That first one, stick side. Great shot. That's the best place to put it there against Barnhart, and a good shoulder save there on the stick side. Second one, textbook again. Take the puck right in the middle of the middle of your body and ice it.
Faceoff win for the Broncos. And finally cleared out by Illinois. It's going to come right to the net, and it is going to be an icing call on the Illini. 37.3 to go in the period. So overall, I mean, this has been a more entertaining period than what we saw last night, for sure. First period to first period. But who would you say has had the better advantage offensively?
Well, I want to say the Illini because they scored late last night, but I think just based on puck possession in this game, you got to go with Central Oklahoma.
Play resuming is Drew Richter. Kolas was open in the neutral zone. Illinois trying to keep it now. And now Drew Richter rushing up ice. One-on-one here. Defenseman coming from behind. Drew Richter shot looking for the lower far post corner, but it's wide of Cody Campbell. Joe Nolan looking to reset. Passing it to his fellow defenseman, Paul Prikos. 12 seconds to go in the first period. Passing in the neutral zone to Ribba. Stays onside. 7 seconds now. Central Oklahoma clearing it out. Met by Moskaluk. Trying to keep it now with four far. He has it, and the period will end here at the Big Pond. So the first 20 minutes gone. It is a 1-1 game. Niall Mills scoring the first goal on the power play for Central Oklahoma, but about a minute and a half later, it was the first goal of the season for Jack Healy as he just tapped it in after a Jack Graham wrist shot, and it is a 1-1 game here.
Yeah, absolutely. I love the play from the defenseman so far. It's been pretty solid. You don't love giving up the one goal, but, I mean, it's hard to do. It's a hard clear, I think, if you're the defenseman. Try and find that puck and clear it as soon as you can. Barnhart, could also be confusing because Barnhart was down on his butt, so he couldn't really freeze the puck there. I think that confused the defenseman a little bit. So you're going to give up that goal. That's fine. Good job there getting it back for the offense. We didn't see him score too early last night, so the change tonight looks good. If you're in the line, I think it's a positive start, but you got to be a little bit more aggressive and try and keep possession a little longer. I think both teams are really doing some sprints tonight and getting good runs, but not being able to keep possessions, I think, a big part of this game so far.
First period in the books for this edition of an Illini Hockey radio broadcast. Again, no video tonight. We are hoping to get that fixed for the next couple of games coming up. We are going to take a quick break, but coming up, we'll have the intermission report in a bit. 1-1 here at the Big Pond.
Have to have
We are back with the intermission report. I'm Patch Kazon. Along with me is Claire O'Brien. Illini off to a decent start tonight. They are tied up with Central Oklahoma at 1. Claire, a decent start from the Illini, but if you had to name one thing that you thought they weren't doing quite right tonight, what would it be?
Well, that's a really tough question to answer, but I think, you know, one thing is that, you know, the offense.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree with that. Opportunities really haven't been there as much as they typically are,
right.
But we could definitely see a little bit more of that.
Yeah.
Illini going to be down a little bit in these next couple of games, potentially, if the defensemen can't get back healthy. If you're the Illini, anything you could try and do to combat some injuries and potentially not having as many defensemen as they typically do and getting stuck with it looks like maybe potentially for the rest of this game, only 4 defensemen. What do you do if you're the Illini?
Well, I would say definitely, you know, try and capitalize on as many offensive opportunities that present themselves as possible. Because you want to give the defense a rest, because you want to make sure that they're energized and ready to roll at all times.
Absolutely. Paul Precos came out earlier in this game. Hope to see him back, but he came out and looked like he potentially might have a head injury. So hopefully no lingering injuries for the Illini tonight and for the rest of the season. But they're going to need it going down the stretch. They got Lindenwood away coming up, so that's going to be a big game for them. Let's talk a little bit about the other side of the ice. Let's talk about Central Oklahoma. Tonight playing a little bit more aggressive. Do they continue to try and be more aggressive or try and set up more opportunities? Because they did score late last night, but the aggressiveness seemed to work for 55 minutes.
Yeah, well, that depends because, like, you want to be aggressive, but not too aggressive as to incur millions of penalties. But you definitely do want to, you know, capitalize on any opportunity, no matter what side of the puck it's on, to, you know, set yourself up for the most amount of success you can have.
Absolutely. You got to remember, too, whenever there's a fight breaking out, that means we get 4-on-4 hockey. So, and whether or not that might be better for the Illini, sometimes you might think they might try and go for that, be a little bit more aggressive, because they know if they play 4-on-4 hockey, they have the advantage because of how wide this the Big Pond really is. It's the reason why they call it the Big Pond. So it'll be... It's interesting whether or not you want to try and be more aggressive. I think if you're the Illini, try and match as much possibly closely as you possibly can to Central Oklahoma. But I don't know. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you want to, you know, if they're, you know, being aggressive, you want to be aggressive back, but you don't want to be too aggressive. You know,
right.
You got to find that happy medium.
Yeah, absolutely. And you think, too, last night it seemed like, you know, they weren't quite as aggressive, but they were getting more opportunities, but they weren't clicking on some of those opportunities. Tonight seems like they're a little bit of a different team. They're trying to run plays pretty quickly. Do you like kind of the speed of this game, or do you think the Illini should slow it down a little bit?
I think, you know, you want to go fast, obviously, so then, you know, you can be a step ahead. But you don't want to go so fast that you get reckless.
Yeah.
So, again, like with most things in life, you need to find that happy medium.
Yeah, absolutely. I got to agree with that, actually, because it seemed like a couple times there, the Illini had a rush, they give up the puck, and they'd leave it up to Nolan and company to try and clean it up. You know, Jack Graham as well, he did a good job. But both of them trying to cheat up a little bit on the offense, trying to get back into defensive zone quickly. It's a good move, but you gotta think, do you think that's at all, that move kind of plays into the fact that they might only have 4 defensemen for the rest of the night, or do you think they just do that to get back early?
I think, you know, the Illini are trying to get back early, but at the same time, you have to weigh the risks.
Right. I think, too, if you are the Illini, you try and conserve your defenseman as much as possibly can, because, you know, you're probably going to have to call someone up or try and find another defenseman, maybe even put one of your big-time offensive players, maybe someone on the fourth line up and teach him how to play defense for a little while. So we'll see what they do. Let's talk about the goaltending so far. Barnhart doing a pretty good job. He gave up that one goal. What are you seeing from him?
I'm seeing, you know, very tenacious goaltending. But at the same time, though, it's a credit to the Illini defense because they're keeping the puck away from him a lot of the time. And Central Oklahoma, they're not taking a whole lot of close shots. So That, I think, speaks more to the Illini defense being strong tonight. But Barnhart is doing a very good job in the goal as well.
Yeah, too. Let's go to the other side really quickly. Let's talk about Cody Campbell. He's having a good game, too. He didn't start last night, but he gets the call tonight. Do you like that move from Central Oklahoma, even though they only gave up two goals really in the last 5 minutes, and you could even blame that one on the defenseman there? Do you like switching it up at goalie?
I think, you know, Central Oklahoma is looking more long-term because they're switching up goalies, they're giving him reps, and I think that, you know, they're looking more at the impact, not just this weekend, but further down the line.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we talked about that earlier this season about the Illini doing the same thing, trying to mix it up between Bird and Barnhart. And I think we've seen a pretty good happy medium, but I think the call to go with Barnhart was the right move tonight because the Central Oklahoma team's a good team, and I think you want to get him as warmed up without getting him fatigued for Lindenwood in a week. So that'll do it for this intermission report. I was Patrick Grazzo with Claire O'Brien. Once again, the Illini are tied with Central Oklahoma at 1. We'll be back with a call in just a minute.
Back here at the Big Pond, we are ready for the second period to get underway shortly. Ori Benatar and Patrick Catazone back with you. 1-1 after one, Illinois scoring after the goal by Niall Mills for Central Oklahoma. Jack Healy got the goal for Illinois as both teams switch side after the Boney zammed the ice. I don't know why I just called it a Boney, but I guess that's just what we're going to call it. The Zamboni zammed
it.
The ice.
I love it. It's a good way to... Why not? You know what? Why not call it that? Because this is hockey, and we I love stuff like that, but
I think I just threw you a curveball there. You didn't know how to respond to that.
I was like, it's a party, all right. That's pretty cool. So, anyways, Illini hockey, we're tied at one here.
And, yeah.
Good opportunity to win this game again and hopefully sweep Central Oklahoma here.
Illinois coming in with a 5-0 home record, getting those big wins against Michigan State to open up the season where they scored a combined 20 goals, then scored a combined 8 in the sweep against Illinois State just a weekend later. And now they're back here at home coming off of the shootout win and currently have scored the last goal in this game as we are ready for the second period to get underway as Illinois and Central Oklahoma obviously bringing in their first lines as we will get the second 20 minutes of hockey starting very shortly as it'll be Bobby Ernsting and Matt Davies on the faceoff. Ernsting wins it and the second period has begun for Illinois. Charlie Salk immediately not getting enough on his pass there. Central Oklahoma almost capitalizing there with Mills, but can't capitalize on it. And now Illinois rushing down ice. Kasper Ribba scored in the shootout last night. Center pass. What a goal by Kasper Ribba!
Wow! That was a heck of a shot.
Just 17 seconds into the second period. Ribba on the right side of Campbell, sniping it into the opposite corner. And Kasper Ribba has given the Illini the lead.
Yeah, defenseman gave him a little bit of space, and he put it glove side there, actually. Great shot, but man, that was a laser.
Central Oklahoma scored a goal that early last night in the third. This time it's the Illini, and for the second game in a row, Illinois has scored two unanswered against Central Oklahoma. And Kasper Ribba, the shootout hero from last night, the only one who scored, gets the goal, his third of the season. And Illinois now have a 2-1 lead very early in the second period as Central Oklahoma win the faceoff and have in the offensive zone. Looking for a response, they get a response! 2-2! Deflected in!
Yeah, the redirection there is good enough to give them the equalizer, so good shot, but that's exactly what you want to see from Central Oklahoma. You want to see that more for the Illini. Get a man in front of the net and redirect a shot into the goal. All right, Barnhart had no chance against that.
Not
zero
even
chance.
30 seconds into the second period, and it went from 1-1 to 2-2, just like that. A Central Oklahoma very, very quickly responding, literally 9 seconds after Kasper Ribba's snipe, and it's a 2-2 game. The final score from last night after overtime. And we already have a 2-2 game, and we're not even a minute through the second period as Illinois are in the offensive zone. But Central Oklahoma getting it back, looking for the rush here. Through the middle is Joel. Shot from Joel, deflected.
Yeah, early defensemen on both sides giving in a little bit, not pressing as much as they should.
Central Oklahoma trying again for a deflection, couldn't get it. That shot came from Drake Cartwright near the blue line. Now Illinois moving it back up ice. Healy there and Novosel next to each other. They're going to have to dump it to avoid the offside as Illinois make a line change here.
Yeah, good job there. Team off quickly and avoid the offsides. A little bit of a mix-up, but why not get the line change instead?
And it looks like we're going to have an Illini penalty. It comes on Joe Nolan, who will go into the box with the second penalty of the game for Illinois. And with 18:42 left in the second period, Central Oklahoma tied the game and now have an early second period power play, their second of the game.
Yeah, and don't love the penalty kill. Last time it resulted in a goal for Central Oklahoma, so defense better be strong here without their best defenseman, Joe Nolan, in the box.
It's been a very busy second period here, and now we got a penalty called on Central Oklahoma, looks like for tripping. So just 5 seconds into their power play, and we're going to get 4-on-4 hockey here. So we're not even 2 minutes in, and we've had 2 goals and 2 penalties, as it looks like it was, I think, Matt Davies there, probably called for the tripping. The public address announcer hasn't even caught up to the Central Oklahoma goal. Now he's got to get another goal in. He's got to get the first penalty by Nolan. Now he's got to get the Davies penalty. So it's 2-2. We're going to have 4-on-4 hockey for a minute 55 in this spacious ice sheet at the Big Pond in what has been an already crazy second period with 18 and a half minutes still left in it. And we've got 4-on-4 hockey now as Charlie Salk moving it.
Yeah, 4-4 hockey, like you said, definitely the advantage of the Illini to get to practice here at the Big Pond, so why not?
Almost a goal there for Central Oklahoma.
Yeah, another redirection chance there. Just misses, but that's what Central Oklahoma's going to do to you.
Oklahoma looking to get it again. Almost goes out of play. I think it was just announced Austin Cunningham got that final deflection for Central Oklahoma's goal, his second of the season. No icing call. Illinois making a line change here. Central Oklahoma's going to reset here behind their own net. Henry Hoffman with the puck, and he's going to pass it outright to Landon Robin. Pass into the middle. Hits off the stick of Yamaev, and it's going to be a line change. A minute left on the 4-on-4. Illinois will only have 5 seconds of 5-on-4 hockey after this 4-on-4 expires. Healy moving it around. Good move from Healy. Trying to get it to Graham. Good poke check there from Central Oklahoma, who now have a chance to rush it up ice. Moving down the boards. Quick slap shot. Almost went in. Good save with the stick by Barnhart. That shot came from Donald Danroth, who came into this game and is still the leading scorer of Central Oklahoma. Paul Precos moving it now. Still no update on Stephen Quinn, who hasn't come back in yet for Illinois after he got hit in the boards. Puck is frozen by Campbell with 17:13 left in the clock. 31 seconds left in the 4-on-4.
You're glad to see Precos back. It's going to be a little bit of a game changer for the Illini just because if you're down to four defensemen, you're in trouble. Those guys are going to be sweating, and with Joe Noll in the box right now, he's getting a little bit of a break, a much-needed break. So not the worst thing that he's in the box right now, but 4-on-4, I'll see if the Illini can capitalize.
Glad to hear you have such a positive outlook on people getting penalties, but that's good. You got to find the positives in everything.
That's a big positive for him, and why not get him so a little bit of two-minute break so he comes out fresh?
2-on-2 Central Oklahoma, glove save by Barnhart. It still falls. Barnhart thought he held it, and he grabs it there at the last second as the crowd was clamoring for him to grab the puck. He freezes it at 16:56, 14 seconds left in the 4-on-4, and it'll be a faceoff here in Central Oklahoma's offensive zone as neither team has been able to capitalize on the 4-on-4 hockey. Faceoff won by Central Oklahoma, comes out to the blue line for Jared Guffey, met by an Illini defenseman. Drew Richter trying to get it. Opilka and Salk out in defense waiting for the pass as the Illini penalty expires, and now they'll just have 3 seconds to try and get a power play goal. Cole has shot. Good save by Campbell with the right pad, and now we are back to full strength, so neither team can score on either power play early in the second period in a 2-2 game. Both teams scoring within the first 30 seconds of the second period. The Illini goal coming from Casper Ribba, and Austin Cunningham got the deflection in for Central Oklahoma. Now they're rushing up ice. It's an odd man rush. Now trying to get a shot off. Good save from Barnhart. Puck still alive as that shot came from Graydon Hull. He's able to get it now. A 1-on-2. Sabo using his speed. Can't get the shot to the other side. And that's still alive there. Looking for a backhand. Oh, it hits off the pipe. Still alive for Illinois. Trying to get it in, and they can't. What an opportunity for the Illini. Still alive here as it came off of the crossbar.
Yeah, that puck was behind the goalie for a good amount of time there. No one could poke it in, though, so we'll stay at 2-2.
It seemed destined to go in. Another chance for Illinois. Sabo turning around for that pass. No one there in front of the net. He was trying to get Justin Reese in there.
Yeah, passed a little bit off. I think that was on Sabo.
It's been a crazy 4.5 minutes in the second period so far. Lots of chances and lots of heart pounding from the crowd, the players, and us. 4-4 now.
Yeah, I'll see if the offense gets set up here.
Trying to set it up, puck flying into the air. It's going to be ruled out of play, and it will be a faceoff at the right circle. 15:17 left in the second period, as that is going to catch our breath a little bit, as Illinois had a really good chance to take that 3-2 lead. Puck was just like kind of floating in midair, and then it just hit the crossbar there, kept falling down. And so far, both goaltenders have had a decent amount of instances where the puck has just been floating there in the net as Illinois wins the faceoff. Pass by Healy to Graham. Passing around the boards. Kolas chipping it up. Novosel looking to trap it with his hand on the board. Gets hit hard there by Davin Burton. Still in the Illini offensive territory. Falls up to Kolas. Wrist shot. Good save there from Campbell. Still alive with the Illini. Looking to center it. And it's going to be grabbed by Central Oklahoma. Now looking for a rush. Support coming for Yamaev. His shot. Good save from Barnhart as it is saved with the backside of his glove. Central Oklahoma keeping it, though. Pass into the middle, looking for Robin was Hull. He does find him. Now he gets hit by Novosel, who's able to win it back for Illinois. And that puck is going to be stopped for the clock stopping at 14:35. We're going to have a faceoff coming up.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, it'll be interesting to see. I wonder if the Illini now with 14:35 might want to slow the game down a little bit. Again, back and forth, both sides, but I think after scoring that first goal, they gave an inch a little bit, and Central Oklahoma capitalized, so why not try and control the puck a little bit more and slow the game down?
Faceoff win for Central Oklahoma, looking for another deflection there was Formosa, couldn't get it. Illinois trying to stay alive defensively, but that is just chipped up into the net out of play. As the clock stops at 14:23, another faceoff coming up as Illinois will make a change.
Yeah, and I think going into this game, Central Oklahoma really tried to switch up their game plan. They're trying to get guys from the goaltender, trying to screen them a little bit more and getting redirections. And we almost saw it there, another five-hole. Would have been a five-hole redirection, but it just misses. Good job there by Central Oklahoma trying mixing it up in this game. And it's evident, too. They already have two goals. With just 25 minutes into the game.
Waiting for the faceoff in the Illini defensive territory. Brandon Formosa just skating around, composing himself before this faceoff against the Illini captain, Bobby Ernsting, as the first line is out for Illinois. And Formosa does win the faceoff, quickly trying to pass it, as parked in front there was Cunningham, looking for his second goal of the game. Now Illinois moving up with Moskaluk. Good speed from Moskaluk, looking for Ribba. He does get it to Ribba. He's in front of net, but his shot just is saved by Campbell as he was just parked in front of the net there and makes an easy, easy stop. 14 minutes now left in the second period. Ribba scored the second goal for Illinois. Can't keep it for the Illini, and now it's with Central Oklahoma in the defensive territory, but it's collected by Illinois, but it's a quick dump there from the Illini. Campbell will pass it to his fellow defenseman, Simon Hobbes, who will do a cross-ice pass. Almost touched, now it falls into the neutral zone, now collected by Cunningham. Cunningham moving it around, staying with the puck, tries to get the shot, hits off of Opilka's stick, and finally redirected by Prikos, but grabbed by Central Oklahoma as they're trying to get a center pass in. Got a deflection goal early, maybe looking for another one. Pass near the point, shot almost looking for another deflection. Barnhart, though, stays strong, makes the save as he stays concentrated there. Now Illinois moving it down, ice.
Yeah, I really like the aggressive play again from the Illini, trying to give the defensemen as much grief as they possibly can.
Illinois resetting in the defensive zone with Opilka and Salk. Opilka passing it to Kolas. Kolas trying to move into the slot. Nice move from Kolas. Little bit of a shimmy there. Richter can't get the final touches. He was open at the back post.
Yeah, Richter had a serious chance at goal there. Just misses, but Illini are going to dump this puck, and I think try and recollect, get a line change going.
Yeah, really good skill, though, from Thomas Kolas there, as that puck flies into the stands as it just deflects off of a Central Oklahoma stick. That'll stop the clock at 12:41 as that puck got into the stands. We've seen a lot of those in the past 2 days. Lots of pucks flying into the bricks, into the nets, near the boards. It's never ending.
Yeah, when I first came here, actually, I was talking to some of the guys here on the Illini broadcast team, and I was like, are you ever worried that pucks didn't come at you? You're like, you know what? It doesn't really happen, but the last couple days.
I mean, we had one just in front of us last night.
Yeah, it was crazy. I was like, oh, man, yeah. I was like, I'll be typing on my computer, and I know I'm going to get nailed with a puck. Like, that won't happen. That's a real fear here now, the Big Pond.
Faceoff won by Illinois, now Central Oklahoma with a 2-on-2. Here comes Niall Mills trying to get around. Looked like it was Joe Nolan. He can't get around him, and now a cross-ice pass towards Healy, but Illinois now resetting with Salk. Salk moving down. He's got two defensemen around him. He gets by both of them towards the board. Support there from Novacell. Pass to the left circle, wrist shot, and it looks like it hit right off the pad of Campbell at the near post. Now a 2-on-3. Nolan trying to stop it with his hand there. Can't. Falls to the net of Barnhart, and Central Oklahoma behind net looking to get it back into the blue line, looking for another shot that could potentially lead to a deflection. Matt Davies has got it, trying to find Mills there as he was cutting into the slot, and it's missed and floating up, and it'll be a reset for Central Oklahoma. 11:51 left.
Yeah, Illini haven't been able to get much possession so far in the last couple minutes. See if they can try to get a puck back.
Mills with a heavy slap shot, but it misses and hits vigorously off of the board near Barnhart. Healy moving down.
Quick line change from the Illini, too. Now looks like they're just going for a clearance, but again, try and stick with possession if you're in the Illini.
And space for Central Oklahoma now as Matt Davies is on the left circle in the offensive zone. Good save from Barnhart. Near the net, now moving to the left side of Barnhart. Pass into the middle. Ribba was there to get in front of Burton. Now centering it towards Mills, but now collected by Moskaluk. Right there in front was Danroth, who's able to win it back for Central Oklahoma. They dump it right past the referee. Reset for Illinois. Less than 11 minutes now in the second period in a 2-2 game.
Yeah, and again, fast play now, trying from the Illini, trying to get something going. Good job here, trying to keep it in without having any clearance.
Puck has been flying like a flying saucer so far. Been three of those in a row. Now finally settling down on the ice, and now Illinois looking to move it up with Opilka. He's got a couple of men in the middle, but now cuts it himself. Reached out for Opilka, good save from Campbell as it comes off his stick in the center of the net.
Yeah, he can't give Opilka that much space. He's going to take the shot. Great shot off the goaltender. Good save.
Illini fans clamoring for a potential hold or slash there on Central Oklahoma, who've only been called for one penalty. Almost deflected in there from Central Oklahoma. Illinois moving it down. Breakaway for Joe Nolan. One-on-one. Joe Nolan. Oh, and what a save from Campbell as it hits right off the glove.
Nolan trying to go five-hole there, and it was closed out. No luck.
Halfway through the second period, as this has been energetic, fast, and both teams have had a lot of opportunities in either zone. Not much play in the neutral zone in this busy second period, where we started with two goals and two penalties combined between both teams in the first minute and a half. Now settled in the neutral zone by Central Oklahoma by Hobbs. Pass out to the board. Hit off the stick of Ernsting. Hatton trying to meet it there. Falls to Nolan, who's going to pass it around to Precos. Pass to Ernsting. Hits off his stick. Missed deflected there by Central Oklahoma. Will be called offside on Illinois at 9:20 in the second.
Yeah, and play lately for the Illini hasn't been too great. They're trying to, they're running pretty quickly, and you know, again, I said earlier, they're running sprints in this game. It seems like that's their game plan so far. But look at the other side, Central Oklahoma trying to get a man and get a screen out front against Barnhart. That's been working. I like that gameplay a lot for them. And again, I said it last night too. Illini's trying to do the exact same thing. So. I don't know. We'll see if the Illini can try and get a goal off some of these rushes.
Offside called by Central Oklahoma. Cunningham kind of whacked the stick of Luke Forfar, and then they just kind of met each other there with a push. Now they're separated. 9:14 left in the period, and it will be a faceoff coming up. The physical play has definitely gone down, but I think when we've seen physicality in this game, it's been a lot rougher and tougher than what it was last night.
No, I think so. Not as much as checking. I think that just goes to the fact that both teams are trying to rush the puck to the offensive side.
A lot of stick whacking, and there's a good hit there on Kolas by Central Oklahoma. Richter gets hit now as he falls down in the center of the ice. Salk shooting it. Still alive there. Kolas can't get a final touch on that. And Central Oklahoma, nice little chip pass, but it falls all the way to the defensive zone. Charlie Salk going to control it and centering it to Opilka in the neutral zone. Opilka trying to get by the Central Oklahoma defenseman, which was Brandon Formosa, in that neutral zone. Campbell passing it to his right. Saucered up, falling to Opilka. 8.5 minutes to go in the second period. Opilka finds a wide open Drew Richter. Now in the right circle. Richter shot, and that's saved by the pad of Campbell. Central Oklahoma trying to move it down now. They've got bodies moving forward. Cunningham, wrist shot, way wide, and hits off of the glass. Trying to keep it in. Onside there was Guffey. He does. Big hit there from Central Oklahoma. No one falling down quite yet. And we will finally have a whistle coming at 8:12 left. And it looks like we're going to have, I believe, maybe a penalty.
Yeah, a little confusion on the ice. And it should. Oh. Yeah, it's going to go against the Illini here.
It will be Neil Novosel going into the box. Third penalty of the game for Illinois. So we discussed the Illini needing to be more disciplined in this game compared to last night. They are a little bit, but now up to three penalties with still plenty of time in this game. So the discipline hasn't been tightened up quite yet.
No. But they, I mean, to your point too, Central Oklahoma is 1-for-2 on power plays here.
Trying to get another one quickly, falls to the center, almost backhanded in by Robin as Central Oklahoma almost getting a quick power play goal. Penalty is slashing on Novacell. Central Oklahoma playing with it behind the net. Mills was there, now resetting it on the blue line. Now towards the right circle. Good passing for Central Oklahoma, looking for a backhand shot. Barnhart freezes it. And we got a little bit more of a scuffle there. That stops the clock at 7:43. Even more hits thrown there. Looks like between Graham and Formosa. Claps from the audience as we are going to get a penalty now on Central Oklahoma. So for the second time in the second period, we will have 4-on-4 hockey, and it will be for a minute 32 as Brandon Formosa will go to the box, probably for roughing.
Yeah, honestly, we've seen a lot of this from Central Oklahoma. I'm surprised they haven't called it yet, but I think refs have had enough. I think earlier in the broadcast, you might want to see the refs might want to reel it back in on some of those calls, and it seemed like they had for the most part. Players have been getting away with a decent amount, but they're gonna call roughing on that one.
Last time we had 4-on-4, not too many chances for either team, but now Central Oklahoma winning the faceoff in the defensive zone. Trying to get an early chance here, Cunningham trailing, and there's a good save from Barnhart. Shot came there from Burton.
Yeah, that one off the stick, good save there, Barnhart.
Still with Central Oklahoma, Cunningham passing it to Davies, who's gonna have to go back to his defensive zone to avoid an offside. Dumping it to Graham. Now Nolan. Penalty is confirmed as roughing as we've got a minute left of 4-on-4 hockey. After that, Illinois will have just around 30 seconds of a power play. So far the Illini have had two power plays technically, but they're only going to last for less than a minute after this 4-on-4 ends, while Central Oklahoma, their last two times they've gotten a power play, they've gotten a penalty just quickly after Illinois was called for one, as neither team has been able to get a good shot yet on this 4-on-4. About 30 seconds left as both teams are down a man. Three defenders now against Matt Davies. Riba kind of hitting with a back check there on Davies, but winning it back. Now to Ernsting, 1-on-1. Ernsting getting support from Opilka. Now passing to the other side to Riba, centering it, and now another shot. Oh, almost a goal there for Nova. It was Forfar. Novacell, of course, being in the box. 12 seconds now, rush for Central Oklahoma. Nice misdirect there as a quick stop from Cartwright brought up the snow on the ice. And now Barnhart is gonna freeze it as he catches it after a long shot. 3 seconds left in the 3-on-3, 32 seconds left on Illinois' on Central Oklahoma's penalty.
Yeah, this will be an important faceoff, excuse me. Here is only 3 seconds left on this penalty. Illini can potentially get a good rush and try and go across ice to get this puck to the other side.
Penalty over for Novacell. Good shot there from Yamaev. He cannot get it in. Illinois got 20 seconds of a man advantage here. 6 minutes to go in the second period. Both teams scored within the first 30 seconds. Puck flopping around and will be called offsides on Moskaluk as he caught it past the blue line. 12 seconds left on the power play. 5:54 left in the second.
Yeah, not too much left now here, so I like the little bit more urgency here. They knew that they had the one-man advantage, and contrary to last night when they did have the power play, and Joe Nolan held up behind Barnhart for a good 20 seconds to set up a play. Unnecessary. Opilka there, good job getting the team out ready right away.
And rare to see 2 4-on-4s where neither team was really able to generate an excellent chance, as both teams are back to full strength with 5:40 to go in the second period. Illinois quickly attacking, Riba trying to get his second, but it flies into the net of the boards, stopping it at 5:36 as that puck goes out of play. Very surprising, Patrick, to see those 2 4-on-4s. Neither team was really able to. It just seemed like the space on the ice wasn't as vast as it usually is, especially in the big pond.
Yeah, and especially for the Illini, because like I said last night, we said it over and over again, they have the advantage on those 4-on-4s because they, practice here and are able to expand that space. But this time, really not doing a good job.
Puck stuck in the corner there. Finally comes out, and it will be collected by Hatton. Skating to his right, trying to pass it to Sabo. It's going to go all the way back. No icing called there. Central Oklahoma trying to get it out of their defensive zone. Comes out into the Central Oklahoma offensive zone. Hatton, though, able to win the race between himself and Formosa. Central Oklahoma with it now. They've got two men in the offensive zone. Quick shot here, and it goes wide. That came from Gage Joel as he was looking for his second goal of the season. Formosa trying to find Joel again near the center. Now Joe Nolan moving it around, trying to fling it away, and it's blocked with the hand by Durbinick, the captain for Central Oklahoma. Hatton moving it up. Precos demanding for the pass. Bit too hard, couldn't control it there. Now centering it, hits off of the stick of Campbell, but no Illini shirt there to try and deflect it in. And the clock stops at 4:26.
Yeah, so this is interesting too. Looks like there's a player injured for Central Oklahoma. I think of what the original whistle was about.
Yeah, down there is it's Gage Joel.
Skating. Great name. Said that last night.
Yes.
Cool name.
Skating back into the game. He's leaning down as he's skating towards the net, but he is going to get checked. Holding his head, and it looked like holding his midsection too, so probably got hit pretty hard. Coming to give him his stick is Formosa, but Joel is going to go and get checked by the medical staff as we are going to have a face-off here on center ice. So third player today to have to go and get checked during the game. Quinn, who hasn't checked back in for Illinois yet in this contest, probably is out for the rest of the game, we would assume. Paul Precos had a bit of an injury, and now Gage Joel checking out with an injury. As once again, Central Oklahoma moving it into their offensive zone. 4:15 left in the second period. Since those two early goals, neither team has been able to quite find a chance. The best chance since the goals was when Ribba hit the crossbar. Kolas moving it around, switching it back to Salk. Salk back to Kolas, finds Forfar, who goes down hard on the ice. Richter now hit hard there by Burton.
Yeah, good play there, too. Trying to keep it in on the offensive zone for the Illini, just unable to do it. Central Oklahoma.
Checks into the boards have come with a lot of force. Center pass looking for an open net, but it hits the side of the net there by Matt Davies. And we're going to have
cross-checking, looks like.
A cross-checking call here with 3:37 left in the second period. And I think it's going to be against the Illini as Justin Reese will go to the box. So the fourth penalty of the game for Illinois. Central Oklahoma is 1 of 3 on their power plays, and they will have a man advantage for two of the next 3:37 of this second period.
Yeah, and we really haven't seen too much from the penalty kill, because that last one we did get 4-on-4, but not too confident in this penalty kills. Last time they were unable to get it out of their defensive zone, so Illini should try their hardest, honestly, trying to clear the puck as much as possible.
Haven't seen many clearances on these penalty kills for Illinois. Can't recall just one time where Illinois has just been able to hit it up ice for what would usually be an icing. As Illinois is on the PK once again. Nolan with a chance to clear it. There it is, so commentator's curse there. I say it hasn't happened, and then it happens.
Yeah, and it looks like almost an opportunity for the Illini.
Reese called for interference rather than cross-checking. That is now confirmed.
Moskaluk, too, trying to give as much grief to the defenseman as he possibly can. Good job.
Central Oklahoma keeping the puck here. Now in the neutral zone. Cross ice pass to the left side. Nobody there. Graham looking to get a clearance here. Find space for it. He will, but it's met by the hand of Robin. Good pass out to Mills. Mills in the right circle. Going to slow it down. Pass to the blue line to Durbinick. Robin's pass met by the stick of Nolan. Both Nolan and Mills falling down ice. Puck is still there under Nolan, but now Central Oklahoma able to get it again. Mills at the line. Almost a shot there from Robin. Now re-centered to Mills. Back pass to Durbinick. No shot quite yet. Looking for another deflection. Finally hit away from net by Graham. Less 50 seconds to go on the power play. Switch here for Illinois. They've gotten in the offensive zone with Jack Healy. Looked like he was getting held there. Illini fans wanting a penalty on that play on Durbinick, but nothing called. 33 seconds to go in the power plays. We're approaching 2 minutes left in the second period, and there is a hard hit there from Illinois. Clock is going to stop at 2:07, so it looked like the puck went out of play.
Yeah, I think, too, good job there by Jack Healy. He's tried his hardest over there and to kill the penalty, really. So good play from him, not trying to find an open man or anything, but just take as much time off this clock as he possibly can. This penalty kill has been fantastic for the Illini.
Still got 30 more seconds to try and kill this power play for Central Oklahoma. Illini did score a shorthanded goal last night. They also got a couple shorthanded goals in their first home series against Michigan State, but they did score 20 in that series, so they were bound to get some shorthanded ones. Another clearance from Illinois. Less than 10 seconds now on the power play. A minute 45 to go in the second. Central Oklahoma is just going to hold the puck. The power play will expire for them, so the third penalty kill of the game for Illinois. And now a pass met by Kolas. Richter now looking to get by his defenseman, but unable to get it. And a great save there by Campbell as he kind of went up for like a basketball block, getting it in there.
Yeah, Kolas with the shot. Like the take, put good part of the ice to take it, and just good save.
Reese back into the game for Illinois after his interference penalty. Kolas on the right circle. And once again, Central Oklahoma just staying right in front, not falling for the move. Good defending there from Burton. Matt Davies moving it down, looking for a center pass. Hole almost deflected it. Now we got 60 seconds left in the second period. Maybe one more rush for both teams as Illinois have possession of the puck right now. Sulk, cross ice to Opilka. Moving it into the neutral zone. Now to Moskaluk. Scored the game-tying goal yesterday that took the game to overtime. That game ended 2-2. This game is still 2-2. Central Oklahoma moving it down. Good move there here. Now behind the net. Maybe looking for a whip around. Quick slap shot, but it's missed by Burton. 32 yeah. seconds now.
Not a great shot there from Burton.
A lot of shots from the blue line in this period by Central Oklahoma. Of course, getting their goal off of a Cunningham deflection.
Oklahoma with a lot of the possession in this this period. Illini got to make a change somehow and try and keep it a little bit more. Slow the game down almost to try and get at that last goal. Make it 3-2.
6 seconds now left. Central Oklahoma might have a chance, and there's a penalty called there by Central Oklahoma. It's going to be on Davin Burton. So with 4.2 left in the second period, Illinois will have a power play. And like we saw yesterday, Central Oklahoma started the third period with a power play. It will be Illinois this time that will start the third period with a power play.
Yeah, and that's fortunate too because you can plan it well. Like I said, that's a great opportunity here to slow the game down and try and get a great opportunity on the offensive side for the Illini. So, shout out to Opilka too. He sold that a little bit and was able to get the power play.
Clock is going to expire as we got another injured player down as the second period ends. And Moskaluk, shock, we're getting a lot of activity here. Both teams going at it. Ribba fell down in the ice. Now he's going to go get checked.
Yeah, Casper Ribba, a great player for this line. Like you said, he scored in that shootout last night. He's the only one to score, and he's a quality player. He scored in this one, too. So it's a bummer if he's out for the rest of this game. A
lot of chippiness in the end of this period. Moskaluk going at it there with Landon Robin. It cools off, and finally these two teams will go to the locker rooms at the end of the second period. So what a start in the second period. We had Illinois taking the lead inside of 17 seconds. Central Oklahoma scoring just 10 seconds later. But Illinois will start the third period with a minute 56 left on this power play.
Yeah, some chirping going on here too right now. Central Oklahoma talking back to some of these fans. Tonight, a good crowd too. They're into it and been able to get some energy for the Illini in this one. So I like the crowd tonight and see if the Illini could come away with this one in the third period.
So Burton is in the box for holding. That is the official penalty. And we are going to take it to a break. We'll have the intermission report soon. But after two, it is 2-2 between Illinois and Central Oklahoma. Thank you.
We are back with the intermission report here from the Illini hockey game here at the Big Pond. I am Patrick Kazan. Along with me is Claire O'Brien. The Illini are tied at 2, an exciting half that, you know, the first 2 minutes. Both teams came out fast. Illini scored with about 17 minutes in, and then right after that, 5 minutes later, or 5 seconds later, excuse me, Central Oklahoma scores. So we're tied here at 2. Illini, kind of not doing too well offensively. What's got to change for them?
Well, I think the Illini can definitely take a few more risks. I mean, you know, you have to play conservatively, but, you know, definitely I think they can, you know, still be a little more up-tempo.
Yeah, absolutely. I think to add on to that, too, Illini hockey has to do a little bit of a better job of controlling the puck for longer. Seems like they're giving up on their plays a little bit. And not setting themselves up for a score. They're trying to score on rushes, which I appreciate too. I think they're changing up a little bit from last night when they weren't able to score too much, but they were able to set up a whole lot. Tonight, switching up a little bit, but I think going back to what they originally had last night will help them score. Let's go to the other side of the puck. Central Oklahoma. They're doing a good job as well. Offensively, they seem to be dominating. What do you see from them to keep, how do they keep the puck and keep getting these good offensive opportunities?
I think they just need to keep, you know, passing and advancing. And I've noticed that Central Oklahoma, when they have the puck, they're usually, everybody's over on the one side. And they're generally by the goalie. Whereas Illinois tends to hang back a little bit more. That's what I'm starting to observe.
Yeah, the defense seems to be cheating up just a little bit, but I don't give them too much grief for that just because they are down. They are down defensemen. They're down to 5, and it's always tough when you do that to play well and keep an offensive zone or keep the puck on the offensive side because you're worried of injury and fatigue for the Illini. But so far, actually, credit the defense, too. with all that fatigue, they've been playing pretty great, only giving up those two goals in the first two periods. I think for the Illini, you set yourself up for a great chance to score in this third period and win the game. Let's talk about the aggressiveness in this half. Central Oklahoma really getting aggressive in this game, whereas Illini is trying to slow it down maybe a little bit on the aggressiveness. Should Illini try to match it a little bit more, or do you think they're good reeling it in?
I think, you know, that's more of a situational thing, but I think, you know, if you match the aggressiveness that you're seeing from Central Oklahoma, you're going to have a very, very, very aggressive game.
Yeah, too. To add on, Central Oklahoma really, really getting chippy in this game. Coming off the ice, they're getting chirped a little bit, not too much where you get a little upset about it, but players are getting upset about it and yelling right back at the fans, which honestly is an interesting move. You really don't see that a whole lot in hockey, but good to see that here at the Big Pond. I think crowd playing a little bit more of a role in this game tonight, just because the volume, how many more fans are here tonight, as well as how loud they're getting. So hopefully that'll help the Illini in this half. Let's talk about the goaltending too. Barnhart doing a pretty good job. He looked a little shaky to start the second period. But what have you seen from him so far?
I've seen, you know, very tenacious goaltending. He's, you know, doing a really good job of, you know, making sure the puck gets absolutely nowhere near the goal.
Yeah, I think you look at a couple of saves. He had that one where his stick side, good save there. And hopefully the Illini trying to get a little bit more shots towards that part of the area, or part of the net, really. That Central Oklahoma's been getting, too. So if you are the Illini, who's your go-to player in this third period to score that game-winning goal?
That's a really good question. The Illini have been playing very strong as a team, so I think it's just a matter of who happens to be closest to the puck and closest to the goal.
Yeah, just want to shout a couple names out because we'll see a lot, hopefully, from them in this third period. Kasper Ribba, he came out, but hopefully we'll get him back for his third period as he scored early in this game. Has been a star of this team this year so far. In terms of that first line, too, might want to go with the captain, Bobby Estring, as long as Johnny Moskaluk. He's been fantastic as well. He's got 6 goals in the season. Want to see a little bit more from him in this game for sure. And then Stephen Quinn, we haven't seen him in this game. He's injured. See, maybe he comes back in this third period and surprises us, but likely not. And yeah, hopefully one of these players will score anyways. Let's talk about the other side of the puck. Central Oklahoma really having some trouble defensively too with some of these fast rushes. Do you think they try and slow the puck down a little bit and try and set themselves up, or do you think they continue with their bull rush?
I think, you know, you have to, you know, play quick, but I think, you know, the thing with, you know, rushing really quickly is that, you know, you can get, it's, you have a greater potential to be sloppy. So I think the Illini need to keep being quick, but they also need to, you know, slow down when necessary in order to, you know, be calm and,
yeah,
you know, have control.
Absolutely. That's going to do it for this intermission report. I was Patrick Gasnell with Claire O'Brien. Once again, the Illini are tied going into this third period. They're tied at 2. We've got a couple of penalties coming up against Central Oklahoma. And a great opportunity for the Illini to score. So make sure you stay tuned for this third period. It's going to be a good one. We'll be back.
Ori Benatar and Patrick Catazone returning. We're getting ready for the third period of Illinois and Central Oklahoma. It is a 2-2 game. Early goals in the second period, but goodness me, we got a lot to talk about after sort of what happened at the end of the game. There were some Fs and some Ss thrown between the Central Oklahoma players and the Illini crowd, leading to, I believe, what was a spearing penalty on Alexander Yamayev. So he has a 5-minute major. Add on to that a penalty by Davin Burton, I believe, which was interference. He's got a minute 56 left in the box. So Illinois is going to start with a power play for the first minute 56 of this third period. And Central Oklahoma's got someone with 5 minutes in the box.
Yeah, 1 minute. We're 1 minute left to puck drop in this third period. And no one come out. And just now, some of Central Oklahoma just comes out. So that's a little odyssey. They're maybe getting a little bit of a talking to because they have been pretty outrageous to this crowd here tonight. And to be fair, they're getting chirped pretty heavily here at the Big Pond. But you never really see people talk back after they get chirped. Mostly they're calm and collected. So maybe speaking a little bit to the fatigue that Central Oklahoma has in this game, because defense has been pretty good for the Illini, other than the that first goal and that their second goal. This is a little bit of a cheaper goal. I don't want to demean the goal, but it came quick. Illini defense just wasn't on top of the game. But for the rest of the 19 minutes, they were fantastic in that second period. And then a power play goal. So a little bit of fatigue from them, I think, showing off and how much they're yelling back at this crowd.
8:45 here in Illinois as it is a 2-2 game. And that's something Nick Fabrini was telling with this team. You know, this is a physical Central Oklahoma team. They have a lot of penalty minutes. It's something that they themselves have fixed in these two games. They haven't had too many penalties. This is probably the first instance in the two games from yesterday and today where we've seen Central Oklahoma really kind of just go over that boundary of what's okay and what's not okay in the sense of penalties and making sure you don't have guys in the box. Illinois has stayed disciplined throughout. They've had a little bit of retaliation, but not to the point where they've got someone in for a 5-minute major, as both teams are now finally out, as we got 20 minutes left in regulation. Do you think, Patrick, we could see another overtime at 2-2? Or is someone going to win?
You don't necessarily want to hope for an overtime, but just how exciting this game has been, I kind of want to see an overtime, and it'll be the fantastic mesh of these two teams going to two OTs, because they're both fantastic, both been fighting really hard. But I want to say the Illini are going to win this one. Watch out. We'll see what they can do quick. Once again, they'll be on the power play, and they've had some time to talk it over. We'll see what play they come out and run to start this third period.
Illinois will have a minute 56 on a power play to begin the third period, something Central Oklahoma had to start last night's game. They scored just as the power play expired, which was less than a minute in the third period. That gave Central Oklahoma a 2-0 lead last night. And we're underway for the third period. The faceoff won by Illinois. Again, they have a power play. A minute 54 left on it. The clock operate. I think the clock is resumed now for the power play. It stopped there for a couple of seconds. They might have to speed it up a little bit, as we've got a minor and a major penalty for Central Oklahoma as the third period has gotten underway here, as Illinois have it in their offensive zone. Finally have a stay of possession. Ernsting passing it near to Moskaluk. Now Opilka. Slowing it to Forfar. Forfar back to Opilka. A little bit of a back and forth between the two of them. Still passing back and forth. Can't find an opening for a shot. And now Ernsting will go where Opilka was, which is right behind that left circle. Ernsting will go with a wrist shot. Good save there from Campbell as he positioned himself well towards that near post. A minute 18 on the power play. 19:17 to go in regulation.
Yeah, you know, I'm interested in that play because you would think the Illini trying to spread the puck out a little bit more, but they're all fairly condensed inside that zone, trying to get the puck to the crease, but really not a whole. Don't love that play. Trying to spread it out. Big Pond's a very wide arena, so try and use that space.
Shorthanded chance now for Central Oklahoma. Just careened off the stick of Barnhart. Also, Casper Ribba is back in the game after a late injury in the second period, so he is now skating with the puck onto the left circle, skating around the net. Passing it to Tyler Opilka on the right side of the blue line. Now to the left side to Forfar, who passes it now to the captain. Ernsting now center pass into the, in front of the crease. Net dislodges. Couple guys getting hit. I believe Nolan's the one that falls. 18:47 to go, 48 on the power play, and 3:52 left on the major penalty as Illinois will bring out their second power play line.
Yeah, and that time using the space a little bit better. I like that more. Try and set a screen here because might be able to pull more players in and then try and pull more players towards the center and get some open space around on the boards and maybe try and take a shot around there towards the side. But I don't know. We'll see what the Illini come out here. 48 seconds left in this penalty, so they got some time to hopefully run more than one play and try and find the open guy. I like Nolan here. Watch out. He might take hopefully, Philly wins this face-off. They go to Nolan. He takes a slap shot and try and get a redirection. Watch out for Richter as well. See if he could plant himself right in front of the goalie.
No face-off quite yet. Ernsting was talking with the officials about maybe some more potential discussion. So right now the officials discussing something with the guys behind the boards there near the penalty boxes. So the captain, Ernsting, representing the team here in this discussion with the officials.
Yeah, I wonder if Ernsting is wondering how much time is left in this penalty because it did start late, like you said. Maybe checking it over with his team because, I mean, you can see it right. It doesn't look right, obviously. And 48 seconds left in the penalty and 47 seconds left until 2 minutes is over. So that just doesn't add up.
There we go. So they subtracted 5 seconds. So Illinois does have 43 seconds left on the penalty. So the operator there didn't continue the clock there. So it was stopped for a five-second period. So there is 43 seconds left on the power play. I think Ernsting is questioning that. I'm not sure. It would be quite the sportsmanship move to say, hey, we have less time on our penalty, but obviously we can't hear what they're saying. We're a bit too high up here in the treehouse at the big pond to get exactly what the players are saying. If only we had, again, we need those GoPros in net. We need everyone mic'd up. That's the next step in Illini hockey broadcasting. Getting every player mic'd up as the second line is out for the power play. Salk passing it to Joe Nolan as they're the two defensemen on for Illinois. Back and forth between them. Nolan in the center. Pass to the left circle to Salk. Now out to Olaz. Slap shot from Nolan, as you said, and it's just missed. And that will stop it at 18:29.
Yeah, honestly, good screening there. Richter was paying attention, trying to get to the puck and screen the goalie. Good job there, and we'll... I wonder what the call here, actually. I'm not sure.
Maybe an offside, not sure. The faceoff is near the neutral zone, and that little red circle is Kolas into the corner. 20 seconds left on the power play. 3:22 to go in the major penalty for Central Oklahoma. Richter's got it now, looking for some space for a shot. Can't get it off. Salk has got it, and he's going to pass it to Nolan. Nolan centering it now to Salk, who's loses possession a little bit there. Jack Healy looking to meet with him, and now Healy does get the puck. Healy scored the first goal of the game for Illinois. Casper Ribba getting the second one early in the second period. So, penalty expired for Illinois, so another PK successfully won by Central Oklahoma, but good passing here for Illinois. Puck flies in front of the net, unable to get a final touch there was the Illini. Nolan's going to pass it now onto the right side. As they're expecting left. Nolan's setting up for another slap shot. Kolas is going to shoot it, though. Gets hit as he shoots. Richter able to recover as Illinois has had the puck in their offensive zone for about a minute. The crowd wanting a penalty there. Potentially a slash on Central Oklahoma. Salk shot falls into the middle. Good save from Campbell. Central Oklahoma now keeping it, but one back by Illinois. As Salk has it in the neutral zone. 17 and a half minutes left in the third period. Joe Nolan near the right circle, redirecting himself. As Bobby Ernsting come back in the game, and Drew Richter's going to go to the bench to have John Moskala coming back in. Nolan pass hits off of the skate of Ernsting, recollecting himself near the net. And Illinois has had the puck for about 2 minutes here. Central Oklahoma hasn't even gotten a chance to get a real touch of it in the first 3 minutes of this period.
Yeah, the penalty kill doing not that great of a job for Central. We'll see. Illini can capitalize, but they're still on the penalty kill or penalty power play. Just not the 3-on-5 anymore, too.
Still a 5-on-4 here. A minute 38 left in the major penalty that was a spearing call after the second period ended. Illinois trying to capitalize on this long power play here in the third period. As the pass goes around to Opilka, turns around and gets it. He's got Ernsting behind him, and Opilka will pass it to Ernsting. Ernsting moving forward, looking for Forfar. He does find him. He's going to go back towards the center. Now Ernsting near the net, turning around, keeping possession for Illinois. Ernsting now centering it. Falls out to Opilka. Opilka almost taking a wrist shot. Now he does. Hits off of the stick of, looks like, Matt Davies, who will come to the bench. And Illinois is going to get it again. A minute to go here on this power play. Ernsting, less than 16 to go, flies over the head of Hobbs. Collected by Drew Richter. Good pass from Colas to Healy. Healy's on the right circle. He's got Ernsting behind him in the slot. Illini, all Illinois in this third period so far, but haven't been able to really test out Cody Campbell yet on this lengthy power play. Ernsting, near the right side, hits off of the skate of Hobbs, who is going to rush it up ice shorthanded, and he's finally going to dump it off with 26 seconds left on the penalty, and Illinois might come out empty-handed, but maybe a chance for one more rush here with 20 seconds left as Opilka skating down ice quickly on that right side. Wrist shot, good save from Campbell. Opilka trying to rebound it. Pass from Richter to Opilka. Back to Richter. 10 seconds left on the power play for Illinois. Healy moving it around, trying to keep possession for Illinois. He does as he passes it to Richter. No power play goal for Illinois. A very lengthy, good PK, and there's a goal for Illinois! It's Drew Richter! Right as the penalty ended, and Illinois have taken the 3-2 lead here, 5 minutes into the third.
Richter with a little bit of a no look, looked like he's gonna pass it, and then took the shot. Unexpected. Campbell wasn't really looking for it. And he put it glove side, and that's, you know, that's a, or stick side, excuse me, that's a great place to put it.
Hit upper, man, 90 pretty much.
Richter with the heck of a shot, man. Illini are gonna be up 3-2, and it almost looked like we weren't gonna capitalize on that 3-5. We didn't capitalize on the 3-5. Able to capitalize on the power play 4-on-5 there. So and good job by the Illini.
Yeah, and just like
give
we saw
credit
last night when Central Oklahoma scored as their power play ended when they started the third, Illinois does a little bit of a reversal of that, and another deep shot frozen by Cody Campbell with 14:49 to go. Richter shot right on the blue line. I don't think it got a deflection.
No,
it
he
is
just
a Drew
took
Richter
that
goal
shot.
Yeah.
I thought he was going to pass because it looked like he had Nolan to his left and he might look there, and he just took the shot. And, great shot by Richter, man.
Graham tried to get a shot, but the puck just moving away from him as Richter officially getting his third goal of the season. Jack Healy getting the assist, so he's got 2 points on the evening. Illinois still with the puck here as they're trying to get a two-goal advantage, something that Central Oklahoma did last night, something Illinois hasn't been able to do in this series so far. Pass to Joe Nolan on the left side of the offensive zone. Dumped, looks like, to Hatton. And Illinois has been keeping possession for a very long time as Nolan just kind of saucered it in towards the middle of the net. And still with the Illini, Evan Sabo falling down, trying to stay with it, but it's finally grabbed by Central Oklahoma, and maybe a string of possession here as they got a 3-on-3 going. Nice behind-the-back pass from Davies. Mills finds it. Puck is open in front of the crease. Almost a good chance there for Central Oklahoma as it was just waiting to be tapped in, but they're unable to get it. But Central Oklahoma coming back down ice here. They finally got a shot off in the third period. 13:42 to go. Once again, saved by Barnhart, but still with the Broncos.
Yeah, Illini almost got caught there on a line change. Able to recover, though.
Everyone clamoring for the puck near the boards and finally taken out by the white shirts of the Fighting Illini as Joe Nolan has it. It's been on the ice for a very long time in this game since Illinois is short on defensemen and players in general.
He stepped up.
Yeah, Joe Nolan has stepped up big time as he's going to get himself a rest. He does have a penalty in this game, but thus far he has had himself quite a game. Definitely contender for our three stars, which we could announce in 13 minutes if this game ends 3-2, but Central Oklahoma still has some time to try and get an equalizer. And another late hit there as the puck is frozen with 12:57 left. Refs interfere immediately. Ribba in the middle there with Burton. But I think everything's okay this time.
Yeah,
Some good play from the Illini. We talked about slowing the puck down a little bit, and that's clearly what they've got done here. Obviously, a lot of help from the power play, but it looks like the Illini are going to try and not I don't want to say not score, but try and keep the score at 3-2 and keep possession of the puck as long as they can. And sometimes that means taking less shots, so I imagine that's what the Illini are going to do here for the rest of the third period.
Illinois has probably had around 5.5 to 6 minutes worth of possession here in this third period. Central Oklahoma has barely touched the puck. Illinois did start with a very long power play, scored right as it expired. Drew Richter getting the goal, which is the game winner, as two Central Oklahoma players hit each other. The Illini crowd loving that as Robin collided with Daughtry. That gets a loud cheer as Forfar passing into the neutral zone. Here's Richter, who scored the goal earlier in the period, and he's going to get called for offside, stopping the clock at 12:24.
Yeah, I can't really make up for that one. Thomas Colas just skated a little faster, causing the offsides. Don't love seeing that, but I think that sometimes you get caught in that rush there, and Colas clearly was. Mistake, see if they can make up here with the faceoff.
Illinois does win the faceoff. Novosel got it, but Central Oklahoma immediately getting back possession. Cartwright's got it. Dumping it into towards the net of Barnhart. Sulk was able to get a bit of a tap on that towards Healy, who gets hit hard in the boards, but Novosel gets it. Center pass towards Reese. Reese is still available to have it. Reese shot, and a good save by Campbell as Reese had an open wrist shot there as he was coming into the high slot. 12 minutes left in the third period as Illinois trying to stay undefeated at home. It would be their sixth win at the Big Pond to start the season as they're trying to get higher up in the ACHA rankings, currently at number 3. Healy trying to keep it there. Puck flopping around in the middle of the zone. Now collected by Durbinick. Shot, and Barnhart with a catcher-like reflex save there. And now we got some more extracurricular hits.
Yeah.
Now we got some guys really going at it near the board. Someone, I think an Illinois player might have collided with someone going into Barnhart's post. Two guys are down on the ice now trying to be broken up by the officials.
Yeah, and yeah, you know, I don't know if that was necessarily an accident, but it was a little bit of a cheap shot, and Oklahoma trying to make up for it. And honestly, too, refs missed a cross check on the center ice that could have been called against Central Oklahoma, but no call. It looks like it's going to get a penalty, though. I imagine.
Yeah, Cunningham was on the ice there with Jack Healy.
Yeah,
Cunningham is going to go to the box now, so Illinois will have a power play with 11:38 to go. Healy will not go to the box.
Yeah, Healy is going
to
the box.
No, Healy is going to the box, so it's going to be 4-on-4.
I honestly thought it would have been a good call to just have Healy give him the penalty. It didn't look like he was really doing anything in the scrap.
No, I think they both were. I think it looked like they both were. And in a scrap like that where you see both guys down on the ice and you clearly see them moving around a little bit, you're probably going to have to call the penalty on both of them. And we're going to have 4-on-4 hockey for the third time tonight.
Yeah. I love 4-on-4 hockey. Can I just throw it out there? I think it's always fun kind of down. It looks more like a pond hockey situation that – I don't know if you played hockey, but those were always some good times. And hopefully this will help the Illini a little bit. Again, they're good at exploiting the space here at the Big Pond. So
yeah, I played hockey in gym on a basketball court. I never could skate. Never something I was trained or naturally decent at. I'm a soccer player, so.
I used to play hockey in middle school, and then in sixth to fifth grade, and then I kind of quit. I've lost a lot of my skills skating. It's a bummer. I'm not great at skating backwards anymore, but hey, there's always an opportunity to take it here as a class.
You can skate forward at least. I can't.
Right.
I can't even get on the ice without falling. And
yeah.
I've been on this sheet of ice before, with skates and without skates, fallen both times. So that's why I'm up here in the treehouse telling you what's happening in this game, as there is a stoppage of play right now. Potential discussion maybe for a major. I don't think it's going to be a major, but I think the referees are also. I think they're giving both the coaches maybe a warning. McAllister and Fabrini's players have both been really aggressive, and there's been some extracurricular chippy activities in this game. The beginning of the game, not as much as we saw it last night, but now it's gotten to a level that we didn't see last night, where both teams are now starting to get in like little bitty altercations.
Yeah, and honestly too, more or less, the enforcer is Central Oklahoma. they're clearly fatigued on the ice. Most of what they've gotten has basically been bad mistakes by the Illini, giving up the penalty and them being able to score on the power play. And then, defensemen weren't pressing too hard in the beginning of that second period. That resulted in a goal for Central Oklahoma. So definitely a little upset. Now that they're down, they're going to continue to get chippy on the ice. Oh.
Still a stoppage of play here.
Yeah.
It is going to be a 4-on-4. I mean, there's two guys in the box. The scoreboard doesn't say it yet, but it is. No, it's.
No, it's 5-on-4. It looks like he was the only guy who got the penalty, but.
Cunningham is still in the box right now.
Yeah.
And Central Oklahoma does have 5 men on the ice. So as of right now, it's a Central Oklahoma power play.
Yeah, I wonder what the call is there. Let's see.
Central Oklahoma trying to get a goal on the power play. Falling towards the net. Almost a good shot there. Barnhart extending himself to keep it alive and away from a Central Oklahoma equalizer. So now they're going to control it here. Jack Healy in the box for Illinois. A minute 34 to go on this Central Oklahoma power play. They scored on their first power play tonight. That was their first goal of the game. They're moving it around on that left circle. Passing it back to Durbinick. Now Robin. Right circle shot. Blocked by Moskaluk. Still with the Broncos. Mills. Pass to Formosa. Nice cross-ice pass to Robin. Robin looking for a shot, centering it, and almost deflected there by Dan Roth. Couldn't get the final touch. A minute left on the power play for Central Oklahoma as Illinois on the penalty kill once again. Looking for a nice shot there. Barnhart stays near his post, makes the save. Broncos been able to keep the puck and get a lot of shots on this power play. Dan Roth passing it, and going into the crease there was Formosa, and Central Oklahoma still keeping it in their offensive zone. 40 seconds to go on this power play.
Opelka playing great defense, trying to get down on the ice to prevent any shot.
Central Oklahoma slowing things down. Pass to Robin. Robin cross ice, shot near the post, and it's too high there from Brandon Formosa. Still with the Broncos now in the offensive zone. They haven't lost the puck at all during this power play. Probably have enough time to get one more power play shot. Robin shot, blocked by Moskaluk, who's playing some defense here. Moskaluk quickly going to his bench. 5 seconds left on the power play. Robin has open ice. Robin almost taking a shot. Power play expires, and there's another block from Illinois. That time from Joe Nolan off of his shin pad as the penalty expires.
Oh, ref getting in the way of the puck there. Got to get out of the way. And it looks like line trying to get on a change. Almost got caught there by Central Oklahoma.
And Healy and I think it was Cunningham must have gotten a major because they're still in the box right now. But it is 5-on-5 hockey. 9:06 to go in the third period. Drew Richter's phenomenal shot from the blue line. The difference in this game as Illinois trying to get their second consecutive win against Central Oklahoma in this two-game series. Saucered by Hole hard and now picked up by Neil Novosel. Drew Richter to his right now. Novosel going to go past the blue line. Richter to the bench. Novosel losing the puck there, and it's going to be picked up by Hilly. Pass deflected off of Joe Nolan. Salk is going to move to his right. Nolan is going to pass it, though, to his left side towards Novosel. And it will be called an icing, stopping at 8:31 to go in what has been an aggressive but energetic game of hockey tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. That penalty kill, decent enough for the Illini to get out of it, but only got away with only one clearance. Illini got to do a little bit of a better job there on the penalty
kill. Quick shot, good save by Barnhart. Central Oklahoma has been able to win some faceoffs. They've definitely improved on that compared to last night's game. Now comes the speedy Evan Sabo. He's got two defenders in front of him. Sabo shot and a save off the stick of Campbell. Quick opportunities for both teams. Now Central Oklahoma quickly going down ice as Formosa, who got that shot that was saved well by Barnhart. Going down the ice, Hatton there, tied up with Farstad. Still in the corner of the ice, finally pops out. And now back to the corner to Paul Prikos. Finds Neil Novosel. Novosel's pass errant to Central Oklahoma, but dumped off back to Paul Prikos. 7:48 to go in the third period. Illinois up 3-2. Opilka looking for Sabo. Couldn't get a touch there, and Illinois going to make a line change.
Yeah, good clearance there. I like trying to get the fresh legs on here as these next 7 minutes are going to be absolutely crucial from Central Oklahoma.
Ernsting, first line out for Illinois, Moskaluk. Ribba there to pick up the puck, but he's going to lose it. Central Oklahoma centering it. Bit of a miscommunication there on the pass. Ribba had a chance to get it and maybe get a shot off, but Central Oklahoma able to corral it and rebound after that. But Ribba's now there trying to get the puck. Reese picks it up near the right circle. Pass back to Joe Nolan at the blue line. Nolan saucering it in. Caught by Ribba. Backhanded shot. In front of the net there was Moskaluk trying to get a deflection, but he was unable to. Less than 7 minutes now.
Love that play by Ribba. Wasn't a good shot, so he knocked it down and tried to get a shot himself. Good play.
Illinois picking it up. Polaz dumping it. A stick was flying up into the stands, and a bounce-handed catch. That was a tremendous non-hockey play there from Justin Reese. The stick did like a 720 midair. Bounced off the ice, and Reese catching it one bounce. That might be the play of the night there. Next to Richter's goal. That was pretty cool. But Illinois moving it up ice now. Nolan just going to dump it up. Keeper makes a bit of a mistake. Goes to Illinois. Campbell recollecting himself as he slipped there. Kolas passed through the middle. Hits off of the skate of Guffey. 6 minutes to go in the third period. Central Oklahoma pushing for the equalizer. Nice big hit there by Evan Sabo on Niall Mills in neutral zone ice. That was probably the biggest hit of the night.
Yeah, that was huge.
Sabo was
another big hit.
Staying with Illinois, but that is going to be a penalty on Evan Sabo. Two consecutive hits from Evan Sabo. And with 5:46 to go in the third period, Central Oklahoma is going to have a power play.
Yeah, and I thought this down the stretch. Illini, again, not having the greatest penalty kill tonight. You got to think, too, after this penalty's done, potentially taking Campbell out if you're Central Oklahoma and doing 6-on-5 to try and score that last-minute goal and trying to even it up. So Illini hopefully can improve here on this penalty kill and discourage Central Oklahoma from doing anything like that.
Another PK for Illinois, who've been able to stop Central Oklahoma since conceding that first power play goal in the first period. Central Oklahoma had had pretty much all the possession on their last power play. Shot near there, looking for the top corner was Durbinick, but he was unable to find the net. The call was interference on Evan Sabo. Less than 5.5 minutes left. Mills around the net. Pass to the right circle, looking for a deflection. Still alive, and finally cleared by John Moskaluk as it goes right to Campbell. He's gonna stop it, pass it behind his net, and it's going to be grabbed by Formosa to reset the play with a minute 22 on the power play. 5:06 to go in the third period. Central Oklahoma down by one. Durbinick trying to saucer it up. Remet by Formosa. Broncos moving it around the left circle. Pass to the blue line to Durbinick. Back to Robin on the right side of the blue line. Dumping it towards the corner. Mills is going to be able to get it near the net. Central Oklahoma looking for another center pass. Goes to Casper Ribba. Ribba will clear it.
Slashing call here. Just a dumb play there from Brandon Formosa. You can't do that. Got frustrated there by Nolan, and he's going to be sent to the box.
And once again, that's another instance where Central Oklahoma had a power play but commit a penalty during it. And for the fourth time, we're going to have 4-on-4. So 48 seconds left on this power play for Central Oklahoma. No more. Now it's even hockey. So Illinois will have about a minute 12, 13. My mental math's not great, so I'm going to assume it's about a minute 12.
Yeah, and let's talk about towards the end of this game. If they have any chance of doing 6-on-5, they're only going to have about 2 minutes and 30 seconds, potentially less than that because they have to gain possession in order to do that. So Illini set themselves up well. It's just a poor move by Formosa. You can't make that kind of slashing move. That's dumb and fatigue move there from him, so you just can't do that late in this game.
Richter wins a faceoff, and he slashes Matt Davies. Aggressive there, and another penalty on Illinois, completely hacking him. So Drew Richter will go to the box now, and it's going to be 4-on-3 hockey. Davies is still down, in the middle of the left circle. Richter went all out on that one.
Yeah, that's honestly, that was revenge because Formosa did the exact same thing to Nolan on the other end. So, yeah, this is an interesting call right here. I wonder what they're doing because they're... Oh, never mind.
This game might generate a bit of a rivalry between these two teams if they play again in the near future. This game has been rough and rowdy, and it's clear that these teams do not like each other at all.
No, this has been... And two, more or less, I think North both teams at this point are just so fatigued with this game and the aggressiveness that they're going right back at each other. And, you know, that move by Richter, completely unnecessary. Put the team at risk a little bit. We're going to play, what, four on...
Should be 4-on-3 hockey.
4-on-3 for a little bit, for 3 seconds.
We got three penalties to keep track of. So after the Formosa slash, it only took 4 seconds for Drew Richter to slash. And we're going to have 3 penalties here with 4:29 to go in the third. Matt Davies is still getting checked. Definitely has a bruise on, I think, what looks like his left shoulder. Definitely probably worse than a bruise. It's probably not a severe injury, but a bad injury. I'm trying to find the right words here, but my God, I mean, that was just uncalled for, in my opinion, from Drew Richter. I mean, Fabrini said you got to keep your discipline, and that's the moment right there where Illinois lost their discipline and
maybe cost themselves the game because
and they let the Broncos get to them.
If the Broncos score here, you got to think they have the momentum going into OT, potentially if we tie 3-3 or for the rest of the third period if they score 2 goals, but see what the Illini can come up with here. Down when they're down a decent amount, they're able to exploit the space a little better. So we'll see if they can do that for a couple minutes. But 4-on-3 hockey, really playing some pond hockey now. So it's gonna be some fun hockey down the stretch.
The 3 men on the ice for Illinois are Graham, Nolan, and Ernsting. It will be 43 seconds of 4-on-3 here. So Illinois's got 43 seconds to try and get it away. Puck is spinning around like a top there. And finally, regathered by Central Oklahoma, who are playing against 3 men on the ice now for 30 more seconds. A lot of space here. Shot, Barnhart with the save of the shoulder. Almost through the legs there of Barnhart, but he's able to recover. Good chance there for Burton. Now restop there. Ernsting able to get it now. Illinois maybe just going to hold it a little bit here. 15 seconds left with just 3 men. Evan Sabo's going to come out of the box. That puck is just smashed down the ice. And now here come the Broncos. 5 seconds left on Sabo's penalty. Mills reversing himself around. Kolas comes on the ice, and it is now 4-on-4. 1:12 on Richter's penalty. 1:05 on Formosa's penalty. So after Formosa's penalty, it will be another advantage for Central Oklahoma for just about 6 seconds. But Illinois coming up now here in the 4-on-4. 4-4 pass to Nolan. Nolan's in the center. They're looking for
a hooking.
Probably a hooking call there. Not going to be called. 4-4, unable to get a shot off. 43 seconds left to 4-on-4. Joel rushing down. Now finds Sulk in front of his goaltender. Here comes Reese, but met by Hull there. Good defending there and good recovery. Less than 30 seconds now of 4-on-4. Shot into the middle. It's just going to trickle away from the net. More players falling down on the ice. 2:53 to go in the third. Sulk gets hit. Falling down hard. 14 seconds left of 4-on-4. Sulk now hit hard on the boards by Cartwright. Pass to the blue line. Opilka. Richard Opilka off of the glove of Campbell, and finally cleared out. 5 seconds for 5-on-4. The clock is going to stop at 2:32, and 4 seconds left on Drew Richter's penalty.
Yeah, so, you know, Richter's penalty didn't really have too much an effect on the Illini here, but sucked down the stretch. 2:32 left. I think if you're Central Oklahoma, you try your hard, obviously, every faceoff, but if you get this faceoff, try and keep possession and get your goalie off the ice as fast as you possibly can to set up a 6-on-5 situation
and
the rest of the game.
They should set that up that early?
Absolutely. I think, absolutely. I think mostly in college hockey, too, you know, even 3 minutes doesn't seem like that long.
2:26 to go. Campbell still in his net as Central Oklahoma's got 2 minutes and 22 seconds to try and take it to overtime in what would be the second straight overtime game here at the Big Pond. The Illini looking to keep their undefeated home record intact in this non-conference game against the Central Oklahoma Broncos. 2:10 to go. Illinois got the puck in the defensive zone. Drew Richter back on the ice after the slashing penalty. Jack Graham, slap shot. Away from the net, another quick shot from Illinois. Now Joe Nolan trying to get it. Moskalok able to dump it off to Novacell. Less than 2 minutes now to go. Another hit into the boards by Central Oklahoma. Trying to get possession of the puck here. Illinois and Central Oklahoma toughing it out. Now here comes the Broncos. Hole, right side. Center pass and sticked out by Barnhart. He's able to poke it away. Pass off the board from Illinois, and they're going to change lines here. Central Oklahoma get it in the defensive zone. A bit of a misclearance there as it was hit off the board. Not too hard. Moskalok gets it center pass, and that is intercepted by Central Oklahoma. Minute 25 to go. Three defenders for Illinois now. One man for the Broncos as they make a line change, and it's going to be an offside call with a minute 19 to go. Campbell still in his net.
Interesting call there, not to even go, not yet. I mean, looks like they have a set time. I imagine it's going to be around the 1 minute mark to try and pull a goalie, but Central Oklahoma has been able to keep possession for a good, like, long periods of time throughout this game. I don't know why I didn't feel more confident to do that.
Face off at center ice, won by Illinois. A minute 15 left in the game. Ribba passing it towards the net. Moskalok is going to retrieve it as he skates well to the puck. Ernsting and Moskalok there in between Robin and Hoffman. One by Illinois around the net is Ernsting. Ribba trying to volley it in, but he can't connect on it. Two on two now. Here come the Broncos trying to get a goal late. Shot saved by Barnhart as it was deep in the territory. Goalie comes out. Empty net. 6-on-5 hockey now. Oklahoma looking for a goal, and there's a save there by Barnhart as a couple of Illini players collided. 46.4 to go, and Central Oklahoma does have the empty net now.
Yeah, this is where, you almost see their Central Oklahoma trying to pick an hour fight, but this is when you have to be really disciplined because you got 46 seconds left in this game, and you're clearly going to do 5 and 6. It looks like we get a timeout call here, I imagine, by Central Oklahoma. It's trying to figure out what they're going to do.
If you're just joining us here, it's been another interesting game between Illinois and Central Oklahoma. It was 1-1 after one. Both teams each scored within the first 30 seconds of the second period. Been a ton of penalties in this game, and the difference right now is a tremendous wrist shot by Drew Richter from the offensive zone Illinois blue line that gave them the lead in the middle of the third period. And we've got 46.4 to go. Central Oklahoma do have 6 skaters on with an empty net. Central Oklahoma's just, how many shots do you think they can get off in this span?
Yeah, I would have went, if I were that coach on this team, I would have been a little bit more confident in my team just because they've been very good at keeping possession. Again, for long periods of time. With 46 seconds, you maybe get 2 shots here. Two quality shots.
Yeah.
2 quality shots. Maybe able to get 5 most, but if you want to try and get a quality shot, you maybe got 20 seconds to try and set something up. That's what I'd go for.
Big face-off here between Landon Robin and Neil Novacell in the Illini defensive zone. 6 skaters on for the Broncos. Here we go to the end of the game. Face-off won by Central Oklahoma. Shot deflected off of the skate of Illinois. Still with the Broncos here. 36 seconds to go. Pass to the blue line. Still with Central Oklahoma. Looking for another deflection. Puck is going to go up ice towards the net. It's not going to go into the net. But Central Oklahoma is going to retrieve it now with 25 seconds to go. Illinois gets it. Open net shot. Goal, Illinois, from the open net. And it's converted by Neil Novacell. And that should be an Illini win. And the Central Oklahoma players just smack the net down, dislodging it. 2 goals in 2 games for Neil Novacell, and Illinois will keep their undefeated home record intact.
They are extremely upset. Puck went into the crowd. That should be a delay of game penalty. I don't know if they're going to call that, but man, they have this Big Pond crowd has really gotten to this Central Oklahoma team, and you love to see it. And what a frustrating game for them, too. I mean, the Illini just were able to, whenever the Illini needed to keep the puck, they were able to do it.
They scored at great times and were really able to limit Central Oklahoma. I think they really messed them up. The game plan for them just didn't work tonight, and they got frustrated. And we're just seeing the ice, and man, they're not happy.
Yeah, that net took a beating there. I didn't see who smacked the net with his stick, but a Bronco player did just take his frustration out on the net, got good contact with it. And Craig McAllister having a bit of a yelling match here with the referee. I don't think Central Oklahoma is too happy with how this game has been officiated.
Honestly, I feel like they have no reason to not like it, because the refs were laid back for those first two periods. But when Central Oklahoma kept on being physical and rough, they started calling more of the penalties. And that's what we saw in this game. Look, if you're going to be that aggressive, they're sooner or later going to catch on. So they have no reason to be upset with the refs tonight. Let's talk about the goal, too. Fantastic setup there by Klotz.
Yeah, I mean, Novacell just followed up. Empty net's an empty net. An easy one there for him. So Novacell with two goals in this series. That gives him two this season with some assists as well. So he's up to 4 points in the year.
Yeah, and he's on the fourth line, too. So good to see him scoring and the team kind of building all around each other. So, And we're having a little discussion of what's going to happen, because there should technically be two.
Be a delay of game, potentially, yeah.
Yeah, the one with the net and then throwing the puck up to the I have no clue. They might just – looks like they're not – they might just not play.
No, I think potential timeout here.
Yeah, maybe that's –
probably going to come back on the ice. 23.1 to go. Yeah. Illinois is up 4-2. In what will likely be their sixth win of the season. It will be their sixth win of the season. And they're going to be 6-0 at home this year. And next weekend, they're going to Lindenwood for a big matchup. And then their next home series will be early November against Robert Morris. But still 22 seconds left in this game. Central Oklahoma going to be very frustrated at the end of this one, as they had a 2-0 lead yesterday. Illinois came back, won in the shootout. Central Oklahoma had a 1-0 lead in this game. Illinois scored some goals, both teams scoring in both periods. But the difference in this game, two goals. Jake Barnhart just stands there, and that's going to do it here. Illinois sweep Central Oklahoma at the Big Pond, remain undefeated at home, and they finish it here 4-2 in a physical, rough game between these two teams.
Yeah, I've never really, this is hockey. This game was what hockey is, maybe a little bit more aggressive than what we see now in the NHL, but some players here now shaking hands. That's good to see.
At least they're shaking hands.
Yeah, sportsmanship at the end of the day, but, take the player away from the game, just because this game was so frustrating for this team. Like, you understand why they had that aggression mostly towards the end, so... good sportsmanship here at the Big Pond, and animosity.
There's a couple of animosity handshakes happening, but at least it's...
Campbell's not happy.
The way the game went and the way that Central Oklahoma kind of ended it, with just the pissed off they were at how that game ended, you would think maybe no shaking hands, but at least it's happening. Craig McAllister congratulating the Illinois players. Nice to see. So what now for Illinois? They got six wins, all of them coming at home. They go on the road to Lindenwood. They're 0-3 on the road. Last weekend we're in North Dakota, losing to Minot State and 2 to Jamestown. What's it going to take for Illinois to win a game on the road?
Yeah, so, well, a little bit of a confidence boost here, and I think that's maybe what they need. I mean, we went against this is a quality team. We saw a quality team here at home. I think last when we played Illinois State and Michigan State at home, those weren't as quality wins. So much more of a confidence booster going into these games. And hopefully you see the defense play as well as they did tonight. They're
right
down a guy, a little shorthanded. They've been playing absolutely fantastic and playing well into that, into being down, if you're catching what I'm saying.
Right.
Joe Nolan's been fantastic. Seen some of the offense really grow. And they're shooting the puck, which is good. Because sometimes when, like last game when it really wasn't working out and shots weren't falling and going in the back of the net, you get a little shy. They never got shy, and they ended out strong and won these two games. So
before we go, give me your three stars, Patrick.
Oh, man. It's a tough one.
I think Richter's got to be in there, despite the stupid penalty he committed.
Yeah, I want to say I even want to put Barnhart as the number three guy, just because I thought he played a decent game. He kind of showed up Central Oklahoma here. But let's go with Richter with the third three-star. Second star of the game, Casper Ribba.
Yeah, I'll give it to Casper Ribba. I think
And then do you know who I'm going for the final one?
Joe Nolan? No.
I was going to say Neil Novosel.
Yeah, I think he played really well, too. Yeah. He probably had the best weekend amongst all the Illini players, because John Moskalek wasn't much of a – didn't have an effect in this game so far. But Neil Novosel, your number one star?
Yeah, I'm going to go with him, too. And, you know, 1.5 Joe Nolan. He's been fantastic. These last two games have been fantastic. He's a defender, so he might not get as much praise. Let's give it to him, too.
All right, so for Claire O'Brien and Patrick Catazone, I am Maury Benatar. Illinois wins 4-2 tonight and sweeps Central Oklahoma at the Big Pond. Thank you for listening. We're hoping to fix our video issues again. We are sorry for the inconvenience. We'll leave you with one last song before we call it a night. Thank you for listening to us, and we'll see you next time.
There, we're on the air, it's hockey night tonight. Tension grows, the whistle blows, and the puck goes down the ice. The goalie jumps and the players bump, and the fans all go insane. Someone roars, Bobby scores at the good old hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game. Second period, where players dash with skates aflash, the home team trails behind, but they grab the puck and go bursting up, and they're down across the line. They storm the crease like bumblebees. They travel